Epic Flail Invitational. The stream's disappeared for a bit while we improved the setup. We've now got way better cameras. We've got a Ugandan church cam. We're totally refreshed with a new setup, and we're going to be doing an invitational knockout tournament. How many players are in this? 12? 12 players?
Yeah, I'd say 12.
12 players, knockout round. Person at the end is going to get a possession from a house, maybe even the legendary Land Raider that we keep talking about on the streams. If you're watching for the first time, please make sure you like and subscribe. I'm going to put in the description below timestamps if you're not watching this live, so you can jump to any turn. We're going to be playing on the clock. The players have already deployed. Our members have kind of seen that deployment and been chatting to me and the players of the setup. But I'm going to hand over to players in a second. We're just going to get straight to it. We've got Callum playing his Chaos Knights, and we've got Luke playing his Genestealer Cults, which have the most vile Genestealers you can possibly imagine that we will be zooming in on the camera and just being purely repulsed. I genuinely struggle to look at them. They just look so... They're nice. Like, it's cool. It's a cool conversion, but they're just... Oh, there's just something about the fur that stresses me out. It's like so difficult to see. We're playing Dawn of War deployment. Priority targets is the mission. Supply lines is the mission rule. Both the player lists are in the description below. As we go through the game, I'll be having various rules and stuff pop up on the screen that we can go through in the chat. I'm looking forward to getting involved with the chat, and I'll pass on most of the things that you guys say in the chat to the players. Maybe I'll hold back on a few things if it's might distract them. But if you... No, everyone's been really nice. But yeah, I'm going to hand over the players for them to just, kind of get straight into it and have a rumble. Could be an interesting game because, Callum, you've not played this matchup before.
No, never played GSC.
You have, and you've played my knights and blown them up. But these knights can walk through walls, which
makes them scary.
These ones just stand there and like look over the top and can't go anywhere. So I'm going to pass over to players to get things moving. Come talk to the chat. I'm going to pass that to you, Luke, so you can modestly put that on your top whilst on camera. And Callum, do you want to just really quickly chat through how you think this matchup is going to go, having not played before?
Well, Luke's got a lot of stuff on the board. I can imagine I'm going to kill a lot, which is always fun. But I know Luke has a lot of potential to come back on the board and keep coming back on the board. So as long as I can keep my knights alive, keep some good ball control, I think I'll do all right. But yeah, having not played GSC before, not quite sure how hard they're going to hit. But
We shall see. There's potential there to do some damage, but I need to kill stuff on the surprise turns. Otherwise, you're just going to steamroll all over them. But yeah, there's going to be lots of dead rats all over the place, I'm sure of that.
There is going to be a lot of dead rats. Callum, really quickly, just point through where you've got stuff deployed. I've got the top-down cam so people can see. So just give us a quick point of where things are. Although we will be using the Ugandan church camera throughout the show to keep people up and close to the action.
A couple of units of Nurglings. I've taken fixed objectives. I've taken assassinate and deployed teleport homers. So these are going to do the first one here. Set up a screen here for Luke's aberrance, so I don't get an early charge off here. Melee and shooty knights, so quite an even spread. The stalker just tying the back objective so I can stick it and then move off. Don't really want knights sitting on an objective too long. Nothing too fancy with deployment, just even spread down the board.
Luke, do you want to do the same, my friend, really quickly?
Yeah, two Ridge Runners here. They're basically support pieces that just add to my damage output. Got a little saboteur lingering back here to wander about and be a nuisance. Got another saboteur with the big unit of Aberrants, who's just, again, going to support them. Their big threatening presence in the middle. Gene Stealers kind of as a backup, and some little neophytes guarding this objective. And then lots of other nasty, killy things in reserve, ready to leap out.
Cool. And you've already rolled to see who's going to go first, I believe?
Yes, I am going first. And so I'm going to press the clock button.
Off you go. Good luck, boys. And who's is that Toby that the first thing said is taps watch, no sound, never. And then turns out we did have sound. Mate, if I'd have seen that before I started the stream, that would have been the most stressful thing ever.
Is that Toby?
Oh, I think that was Toby coming in going, taps, watch, no sound. Oh, never mind, that's me. Mate, I'll just let Luke crack on and just do your thing, ignore me. One of the first streams we ever did, who did I have on? I think I had Stuart and Matt, and I started the stream. I didn't have any sound. And Adam stood there chatting through and explaining the list, just talking away, and then sat back down. And I was like, oh, and I didn't like a minute and a half, 2 minutes, and I had to do it again. I made the same mistake again. I don't think they've ever forgiven me. That's why I've never been invited to the Nutsack.
Anything on objectives apart from here?
No.
Well, that and a few other things.
That'll be going away then. Right.
Did you roll for your...
I get to roll an extra dice for that. mm-hmm. because I've got neophytes on an objective.
That's and for the mission rule.
Ready for some Ugandan church cam already. Here we go, boys.
Right, yep. One for the mission rule. So I get a CP. So I go to 2 CP. There we go. So attempting target. That does...
What have you picked?
So attempting target is for the middle one. Yeah. And overwhelming force is the other one I've got. So that's not going to happen. So 8 inches.
I'll teach Luke for trying to be the gentleman and play tactical, not fixed.
Yeah.
Callum, what did you play at Beachhead? Did you play tactical or fixed?
It's depending on matchup, but I mostly went fixed. Deployed teleport home runs and either cleanse or bring it down, depending on my opponent's list. A couple of missions I took tactical, if they had like a lot on the board.
What did you find your opponents were doing? Just similar thing, just matchup dependent.
Yeah, pretty much. A lot of people get drawn into taking bring it down against knights, but to score you still have to kill them. And that's obviously with ways to regain wounds, it's not always the easiest thing to do.
Yeah, fair.
With teleport homers.
Yes.
How far have you got to be?
Within six.
So currently you could get, ignoring the Nurglings, you could get that guy if he goes for a wall.
Yep.
And then anyone else?
I would have thought so.
I don't know if, can you get overwhelming force turn one, Luke? I don't know if you can. This could just be a ploy from Matt to waste time. It could be like, question for Luke. He's like, where's all his time gone?
Yeah, so I'd need to.
Yeah, first turn is maybe a bit rough here, guy. I agree.
Because you can only do...
No, I can get another one here.
But I thought only one could move through a wall.
Two.
Oh, okay, so two could go through.
I'm worried.
But anyone over here at all, or just the two that you would choose for that?
Right, Matt, you're on a yellow card for what I like to call unnecessary player distraction. Consider this a yellow card warning. I need a soundboard for that.
He's 12.
Okay, so he's all right as well. So yeah. He could do it. He'd have to get into that little bit. So I'd have to push back quite significantly.
So tempting targets the middle one and then the other secondary is overwhelming. And the mission... Let me grab the mission cards.
Mission cards,
maybe.
So we've got Dawn of War, obviously, as you can see from the Dawn of War deployment on the table. And then priority targets, which is at the end of each command phase, player whose turn it is scores 5 VP for each objective marker they control up to 10. And then 15 at the end. And then supply lines in this mission. If a player controls an objective marker in their own deployment zone at the start of their command phase, roll a d6 and a 4 up to get a CP. Don't forget that, Luke.
Yeah, I did that one, thank you. So I rolled...
Oh, sorry, that's me distracting him now.
Neophytes on objective.
Here we go. Ugandan church camp coming in. Let's go a bit
more. Toughness there, Abram.
Look at this, you like that, boys.
With something that's higher than their toughness, it's -1 to wound.
Those that haven't joined the stream before, I've seen Luke's Genestealer Cults army. You have to be careful saying that second word with the YouTube algorithm, and particularly how they play sometimes. It does inspire you to say another word that sounds very similar. But they're all beautifully converted into rat men. Look quite cool. Other than the Genestealer unit, which is absolutely disgusting.
Easy to go to there. Just going to roll an advance for him, so he's just then going to go 4 inches. Is back to here.
Mm-hmm. So you're not attached, no?
No, he's the saboteur. Yeah, he's the lone op guy. So he's just going to go there, and then.
Are you just after another card?
The Genestealer is going to advance. 4, so they can go 12 inches.
Guys, a very good question. Oh, there we go. Tom Green with a £2 super jack for the Ugandan church. Do you know what? I really need like a soundboard of like a Ugandan preacher, don't I? So when I go to church camp, it's like
It's a bit of Ugandan preaching.
Through the gap on the wall, right?
I presume so. Yeah.
Any super Tom? I think we should have a super chat rule. If someone super chats the Ugandan church, you tell us what you want to see, mate. What do you want to see? So this, the camera is, the floor is yours.
Get them all in. Hell no. But yeah.
Josh, is rats a significant improvement over pigs and goats, Callum? Oh, man, I'm going to get him to tell that story, actually.
I mean, they're not all going
to... Yeah, you'd only be able to get, like, one line before you ended up deploying the other side of the wall.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, you wouldn't be able to chain your bases then, would you?
Callum, while Luke's thinking about stuff, tell us the pig and goat story. And Luke, if it's distracting you for something, what you do is tell Callum to stop.
I mean, this matchup's no better, really, because the first time I played GSC... I got to the table and had a clue what I was playing because all the models were pigs and goats. And I've turned up today and they're all rats. So, it must be a GSC thing.
Describe what type of models were there? Like sort of children, like what model?
I've definitely done it on the cheap. You know, like the kids' farm animal buckets you get. It was a load of them. I mean, granted they were sprayed brown, and his transports were what looked like to me pound shop tanks with some GW bits glued on. It was a very strange game of 40k.
I absolutely love that. I love the pound shop tanks is pure class. I like that.
That is hilarious.
Yeah, I still don't have a clue what anything is. Yeah, so. It's a little more obvious at least.
All right, 24. We've got range 7. Right, okay. So, shooting. Mm. I'm going to shoot some stuff. I am going to fire an Achilles Ridge Runner at this unit of Nurglings.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So, it is D6 shots plus 3. So, 9, 3, 6, 9. BS3 goes to 4s.
That was a good roll.
That was a very good roll. String 6, so 2, no AP.
6 up in one. Damage?
Just 1 each.
So the front one is on 2 wind left.
Yeah. And then the other Ridge Runner is going to shoot what's it called? Let's go for that unit
in Oglings. I absolutely love that. I'm all for those kind of like, what do you mean? You can't see them at all, just like snapping things off or like filing a model down.
Another 3.
6s. One apiece.
Okay, the...
Yeah, no, I'm only joking. It's definitely a K-word move.
Long range gun, but this one here will fire his 24 inch range indirect gun at the Nurglings.
Mm-hmm.
So try that again. 2. So I think it might be ever so slightly more shots than that. I might be diddling myself out of shots. Remote explosives. Yes, plus 3. So there was another 3 in there. He hits on 3s, minus 1 with the indirect. Strength 5 that time, but still 2 saves, no AP. Oh, actually, AP 1.
6 up in front.
Oh, yeah.
7 up, so.
Yeah, fine.
2, that removes one.
Kills one, yep.
That's kind of what I wanted, to be fair.
Yeah, I was hoping maybe to plink a wound off and leave it alive, but hey ho. Okay.
So, he will fit more jeans.
Oh, Toby, what a G, mate. The first one in. Absolute G.
So, charges them. First.
We appreciate you.
Thing I'm going to do is charge with the. Aberrants, so I need what, a 3?
Yes, just under 4. 3.
Would you mind helping us out with round the corner there? Because I can't quite see what I would need.
No,
so I can go through the wall, that's not an issue.
This thing's so much more useful for this, isn't it? Than me just pointing at Liam's face on Meta Monday.
32mm. If you want to grab this one, and that's so basically.
Until he leans in front of it, don't mind.
Yeah, you need a 5 from this front guy.
Okay. So 5-inch charge, then we'll go.
I love that, Toby. What a lad. Nice one.
I'll do it.
Perfect. I swear to God, if I'd have seen the first message, there's no sound, it would have just completely destroyed the stream because I'd have instantly believed it and ended the broadcast and have to change the entire link setup again.
Interesting, because now I have to.
Here he is, Telly. I was just telling you, I was saying earlier how insanely good Helldivers 2 is. And now all of us need to get on Helldivers 2.
There.
Oh, thanks, Guy, mate. There's a lot of my money going into these cameras, so I'm really happy that you say that. Just need Luke to move his arm and I can use the Ugandan church camera a bit better.
To leave not enough gap to fit another one in there. Yep. So what I'm trying to do is basically push it. String out so you can't end your movement within 12. Anything else is the hope. But obviously I've got such a big charge that I then have to, I think most of the units, in order to maintain coherency, most of those are going to have to hit an Urgling of some kind. So...
Right, no, Tom, what you're about not trusting me? I've got great reviews, mate. I'm all about the good reviews. I've experienced so much.
And then this guy, if he joins in there, and then I've got two models within.
Telly absolutely loves it. Last night, I think I team killed about 5 times in 10 minutes. Yeah, he was like just going completely. He just did a little sigh. Just a.
To the stake.
What's wrong?
Well, so I've got an 11. I can go pretty far. So obviously outside of 6. So just existing.
Yeah, that is the downside, Guy. The servers are awful. Like. It is very, very, very buggy. But once it's going, what a game. George, legend, appreciate you, my friends.
To get the deploy.
To get deploy in your turn one. Yeah.
Well done, Tom. Good lad.
And then they'll just go in.
Say what I discovered the other day as well. For those of you that have PS5s and a PC, you can just get the PS Remote Play app and literally just play... the PS straight onto your PC, which is incredible if your wife or partner is addicted to reality TV shows and won't stop watching them. You can just sit and shoot people or kill your friends on Helldivers.
Just then what I want to do with these.
Tommy's joking, it's not, it's amazing.
Could roll the charge and then see if I can tag a... Could you fall back and charge?
No.
Or fall back and shoot or anything like that?
Brandon, I was meant to be playing in them with Liam, but one of my flaws is diary management, and it turns out that it's my brother-in-law's 40th, so I have to go to that, I'm afraid. So we are streaming all the other incursion events we're streaming. And welcome, Kalos, my friend.
Basically on the ground floor, but mm-hmm. There.
So Luke's, it's interesting from Luke here, he's deployed a little conga line of aberrants, sticking straight out in front of Callum's deployment zone, trying to pen in those Chaos Knights. He's currently touching the most horrendous models, the Genestealers, you can see there, which he has custom built and put fur on, which genuinely makes every fibre of my body repulse. It's disgusting. They look like rotten rotten flesh type things. But yeah, Luke is going for Operation Pen You In. What do you reckon to that, chat? Have a good look. Now with the advanced camera setup we have, you can actually see deployments. What do you reckon to this setup, chat? I won't pass it on to the players because I don't want to mess around with their... game, unless you're super chatting, which guys are saying if no, I'm joking, I'm not gonna mess.
And then, so combat first. I mean,
Nurglings do make you -1 to hit,
-1 to hit. Okay, so I've got 1, 2, do this one. I'll do the
Kalas. It's sort of like a 40k knockout, it's sort of like a mix between 40k Starship Troopers. Yeah, 40k Starship Troopers merge.
8.
It's bloody good, mate. It's fun. It's just for the handle, the shooting on the guns is just a mint. It feels really good to play. It's really smooth.
And then strength 4, one dev wound, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 saves.
sixes. So four go through, plus this one. Damage?
Just one damage.
So five wounds total.
Cool.
Callum, someone's asking in the chat, isn't that only in melee? But I was not listening to what you were saying, so I apologise if that's irrelevant.
What, the minus one?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is melee.
There you go, George, it's melee. Adam, who's the bloke with the way too tight shirt? I love his guns. There we go, some nice feedback coming in for Callum.
Three.
Welcome, Adam. Good to have you in the chat, my friend.
There's a couple of you, mate. This thing's looking strong.
One lethal. So three, and then...
George, yeah, they're in melee.
Same unit.
Yeah.
George, you've now got a yellow card, I'm afraid, for unnecessary player interference, which I where was my decision, but, you know, you're the driving force behind it.
So I don't...
Oh, you're too far for you. Catch up, mate, quick.
Okay, cool. So, that's cool. And then 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15.
Why have you got your cups?
It's got to be more than 20 to be cup worthy.
Oh.
One thing I absolutely love about Luke on the stream or just playing him is his cup routine. Has anyone seen his cup routine? It's absolutely superb. He just has little cups of pre-made dice that he just fires down into the tray. It's superb.
Sixes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 go through. Damage three.
Three each, yeah.
That's 15, and so it takes a unit.
There's them Nurglings getting aberrantized.
Yeah, if I hadn't softened them up though with the Ridge Runners, I literally wouldn't have. You'd have Nurgling, both of those Nurglings would be alive. They could be annoyingly tough Nurglings like that.
Can be.
Yeah. Okay.
I wouldn't get hit like that though.
Oh, yeah. The aberrants. I haven't got enough to pile into anything, but what I might just do is. I know I can't move actually, unless I have something to connect into, so they're just staying put. The gene stealers can pile in back to the objective though.
Mm-hmm.
So they'll just do that, I think, because make it slightly. More difficult for you to get to them, shoot them. I mean, you can still probably waste them, to be fair, but it might make a slight difference to what can actually see them, particularly from over this side. So they just kind of do that. And then that means I got a tempting target, and then I will... So, Paul, I'm going to discard Overwhelming Force.
Yeah.
For a CP. Although I got a CP earlier, didn't I? So
yeah, it caps out on one, doesn't it?
So I guess I still should get rid of it because you don't actually have anything on an objective yet.
No.
So you might do next turn, maybe. But I'm still going to get rid of it. So
what should you get rid of? Apply.
Overwhelming
Force. I got a tempting target for five.
Yes.
Cool. And then that's me.
Cool.
There you go, Luke. How do you feel that turn went? Well, Callum, you just crack on and do your thing, mate. Don't worry about slowing you down.
Home objective stickied on a 4-up. I get another CP.
Cool. Yeah, I think it went okay.
Just up to 2.
I've exposed a lot of the units, but the point being to try and deny Callum scoring teleport homers, which I think is going to be quite important because. Callum's got, even though it's nights, you think they might not be that manoeuvrable, they're quite nippy, and he can just go all over the board and not really worry about getting hurt too much because of the redundancy of his army, so he's going to be spreading out and being all over the place. So if I can try and restrict the scoring, it's useful. This is the plan, is the theory.
Cool.
If nothing else, it's just going to annoy him, so...
That is always good. If you can annoy an opponent, then that in itself is a victory, I find, in life. Luke, for the 50th time, sorry, just tell me which secondaries you've now got.
None. I've binned them both off.
You've binned
So I scored a tempting target for 5 points, and I got rid of Overwhelming Force at the end of my turn.
Cool. So you're on 15 because you've turned up painted.
Yes.
And textured.
And textured.
Untextured, yeah.
More textured.
Textured.
disgusting. And I'm on 3 CP as well.
Missed him putting these scars. What, 3
CP was that, Luke? Chat, what do you reckon to that? Interesting, nice aggressive use of the aberrants there, just try to block Callum out of that centre objective and then moving up the Gene Stealers behind. Turn 2 with Gene Stealers is always... Well, turn 2, turn 3 is your party turn, isn't it, Luke? That's when we get to see all the fun stuff come flying down and jumping out from everywhere. So it's... normally you're a bit more defensive on your first turn, Luke, when I've seen you play or played against you. Although, mind you, you have often against me just whacked them aberrants right in the middle and tried to lob them in something, but I guess I've just been a bit too cagey on them when we've played, maybe.
I sometimes find you run out of places to deep strike if you don't start taking the board. And that's a problem.
So, yeah, fair.
Yeah, it's useful to... like the gene. That's one thing I've found about the Gene Stealers. I've not always run the Gene Stealers, but they do serve a purpose of just kind of...
got that Ridge Runner behind
being there. Yeah, Ridge Runner's behind there, yeah.
Well, that Carnival Orange just going to advance. For a 1. So, 11-inch movement gets into here.
Let's get the Uganda boy deployed. Didn't have done the scoring on.
That's frustrating.
So we can see the... hang on. I even put it in. Definitely soundboard for this. So you can see the line of aberrants, the absolutely horrendous Gene Stealers that I'm literally not going to stop mentioning them. I'm just going to constantly bring it up. There's a line of aberrants. Oh, and you've oh, there's a bin. Sometimes you get in a church camera can show a bit too much, guys. That's all part of the fun. Question from Simon regarding the rules: are you playing them as true line of sight or windowless? Windowless? We play in window. We play them blocked out, don't we? Do you want to explain how we play them?
Blocked out. Yeah, no, you're absolutely right. Sorry, I wasn't sure if you were actually asking us.
Yeah,
you're absolutely right. Full solid. It's like the LGT. Basically, they changed it. They used to be open, but much more sensible with the way things are now to be fully enclosed.
Yeah, I found it just a more fun playing experience, like.
Yeah.
Tom and Ollie read the swear word in your comment then.
Luke, if you're happy for me to...
Maybe that is an interesting... Yeah, that is a, maybe... Luke, what? Maybe the jeans? Man, the Gene Stealers are still quite a pun. What? How many points are they at the moment? Actually, are they cheaper in GSC Gene Stealers and Tyranids? I feel like they might be.
Yeah, of course.
They're like the Slovenian families we have. Nice guy. Luke, how many points are Gene Stealers in GSC? Are they cheaper than Tyranids?
I think 185.
They're not then. I think Tyranny's 100. Are they 118 Tyranny's? Come on, must be Tyranny players.
They went down, sorry. So I think that was the one thing that did go down, actually, in the data slate. 150 for 10. And so then Patriarch, 85 points. But if my stuff is a bit more expensive, it's because it could potentially come back, I guess.
Getting another 6.
Sorry, my chairs, but I'm just realised how creaky this chair is. Right, dare I put a link to the stream in Reddit? Chat, I've got an interesting history with posting things in Reddit. The last thing I posted in Reddit, someone said, why is this guy wearing sunglasses inside? Which was a very fair question, because it is unusual wearing sunglasses inside. But I didn't provide any context, so I just fired it in. What do you reckon? Should I put this stream up in Reddit? Might have to deal with some Redditors, that's the thing, guys. We might get some Redditors rocking up.
Cool. So I am going to move into my shooting phase.
Okay, I'm just contemplating a rapido ingress. Mm-hmm. That's the stabby one, isn't it?
Yes.
So how... don't like that.
What are you thinking?
Also, just any feedback on the stream is always good, especially now I've got all this new setup. Any feedback on how it looks or I should change? I'm very open to any feedback. Much appreciated.
That's a strat, though, right?
It's a strat.
Yeah.
Oh, but yeah, that's what I was going to say. Do you think we should have, like, background music when the stream is, you know, like, just little lo-fi beat in the background or something? Or is that a bit annoying? Because I've noticed a few streams do that. They'll have sort of, like, a low-key little beat in the background.
Oh, that's a stabby one as well, isn't it? Mm. Okay, so if I want to be outside of 12... and the range on your shooty boyos?
24. 36 on the stubbers, but it's just a stubber.
Mm. That's cool. Carry on, sorry. I don't think I can afford to, the way you're positioned there. You've been smart, and you've put a combat thing next to a shooty thing, so I don't get too close to you. Yeah, okay, fine.
Cool. So the CP I spent was to give Dreadhounds, so sustained hits, against Aberrants with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 dogs.
Lovely.
Okay.
Yeah.
You ever watch 10 Aberrants disappear in a
shoot? Yeah.
Just brace yourself.
Are you within 12 on all of them?
So this is a lot of shots going into the Aberrants right now.
Obviously, they're single activation, so depending on when you pull, I might not get my melter.
That's fine, but you've got the big guns on there. I'm not going to waste a CP on the strat. If you didn't have enough movement to get them, some of them within 12, then I might have done the lone op thing, but I don't think it's worth it to deny the odd melter here.
No.
I think you're just going to do it on the volume of the other guns, he says. So, yeah.
Ready? I'm going to start with this brigand here.
Yep.
I will start with the melter. So, hitting you on twos. So, two hits.
Yep.
Strength 12. So, it would be twos to threes because you're minus one.
Yes.
One goes through, AP 4.
Cool. So, my armor save is only 5, so straight through to my Feno Pain. So,
D6 plus 4. So, that's 6 damage on one.
And is it plus 4 always?
No, when you're in melter.
Goes with my hushed commentator voice.
12.
So the players now are just...
just within 12, because this guy...
shooting each other.
Yeah, and I think this one is within 12.
Callum's using a tape measure there.
You start pulling from here.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. So you did 4 plus 2, was it?
Yeah, so 6 damage.
So 4 up, feel no pains. So 1, 2, 3, just kills one.
And then I will go with the stubber. So rapid firing at 18. So 2s, sustained.
Why can Chaos Knights hit on 2s and Imperial Knights, clearly the more noble, drilled faction, be hitting on 3s? This is a side point.
The big knights are better. Strength 5, toughness 6. So 5s.
Yep.
John Virgo, dead or alive. Who's John Virgo?
Never watched Big Break.
Do you know what, Tom? That would have been an insane name to get me on that, because any name and Dead or Alive would definitely get me to read it out. I read that out then and thought, oh, no, I've just done another one.
One goes through.
Big Break. Oh, Big Break.
You.
What was the theme tune, someone?
Chain Cannon.
Chain Cannon.
I'm going to find the theme tune. I don't care if it's copyrighted.
All hits. One sustained.
It's only a game show.
Strength 6, so when you're on fours.
Did you put sustained in? I saw a 6 there.
I put one in.
Yeah, cool. And fours for these, even with a minus one, or is it not minus one?
These get minus one AP against the closest, so these will be AP 2.
AP 2.
One damage each.
One damage each. AP 2, so no thingies, just thinner pains. Ugh. So I should have done that separately, but I failed them all anyway, so I kill... Actually, no, it wouldn't have mattered, because it's doing them one at a time.
Yeah, they're only one damage.
Yeah, one damage is not an issue.
On to the next brigand. I'll go again with the one that's furthest away, so I do get a damage buff. You're starting to pull from there.
Mm.
Here we go, I've got it.
So I just nudged your model slightly then. Probably in your favour, to be fair, because now he's further away.
I mean, if it looked like he was in before you noticed him, then I'll take the word for it, mate.
Sure.
Yeah.
So that one is in. So put up a real good fight. I'm gonna be snookering you tonight.
Use Imperial Knights.
12, so 2s up 3s. And then the stubber.
So that's a hilarious comment.
1 miss, but 1 sustained.
Yep.
5 still wound.
I feel like reading it out just to give you the satisfaction.
2 at no age.
Mystic Meg's a good one. Zedra Line Mystic Meg, dead shit you at the comment.
Oh, but you've allocated over here, so you wouldn't be able to claim cover, would you?
Oh, okay. So it's still 4 from a payment. So one wound.
So that's his guns down. The next brigand will go with the melter. So hitting on 2s. With 1 sustained.
Oh no.
3s. 2 at AP 5 now because you're the closest.
Yep.
D6 plus 4 each. So the first one takes 6.
Okay. 3. 4 ups. Takes a wound.
Wow.
Beast it.
Second one. 9.
Took that personally, did you? Oh, me. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 for no pains. That'll do it.
Kills one.
Kills one.
Stubber. 2 misses, but 2 sustained. 5s.
Right. There's a serious... There's a very competitive game with Dead or Alive going on in this game.
One damage.
So that's technically failed the save, because that was a 6-up save.
Yep.
There's only AP1, and then I've got to do a 4 no pain. Four no pain.
Fine. Yeah, cool. 6, 3, and 6, and then the chain cannon.
Yep.
No sustained.
No.
4s.
Let's do some dead or alive polls, I reckon, lads. Are you ready?
6.
1 damage, please.
So, kills 1. And then 1's left on 2 wounds.
Stalker will go next. So I'll fire the Havoc Launcher first. While I can still see you. D6 shots, plus blast. And you've got 6 in the unit, so plus 1. For 7 shots. 6, 7. Hitting you on 3s. 2 misses, but 3 sustained.
Sorry, I've gone quiet. I'm just currently logging in so we can do some live poll. Polls? Whatever the right word is.
5 into T6.
On, dead or alive.
You do have a friendly unit within 6.
I've also put it on Reddit, so brace.
Is pretty close.
So I don't get my plus 1 to wound, so 5s. 3, no AP.
So 4 up saves. No.
1 damage. Then, takes 2.
Takes 2.
And then I've got this group of brigands here to do. I'll go with the one at the back first because he's the furthest away. Still within 12.
Right, here we go. Let's do some top level dead or alive in.
Melter. Mm. 1 sustained.
There he is.
2s up to 3s.
Mm-hmm.
3 at AP 5.
Okay, so feel no pains all the way.
So damage for 8.
4, 6, 8. Kills 1.
Second one. 7.
Tom, you mean the Gladiator? Do you know what? Do you know what's a great game? Working out what happens to the Gladiators. I think we might have had this on the stream before because it's some of the stuff they've got up to is insane.
I'll go with the stubber next. 2s. 1 miss, 1 sustained. 5s. 3 at AP1.
Callum, just try and keep your head up.
Oh, sorry,
straight, man. No, just straight under that camera. If that makes sense.
Yeah.
You start, cheers.
3 at AP.
Come on, Dick Van Dyke, dead or alive? Obviously the yes is dead, no is alive.
4 ups. 1 wound goes to 2.
How many left now? What, 2? And a dude?
Yes. Chain cannon?
Yep.
Well, you've done pretty well, though. He's dead.
1, 2, 3.
So 83%. If anyone's got a better I guess this is a competition. You give me a dead or alive, I'll poll it and see who can get the trick the most people. So I've done absolutely awful there. I've only got 16% I've tricked.
I win your fours here, Luke.
Yep.
That wasn't a great roll. Three at AP2.
One wound. One wound.
I've still got another two brigands, haven't I?
These aberrants taking a bit of a tickling.
They've got three guns each. Melter. Threes. One AP5. Damage is D6 plus four, so six.
Five. Sorry, how many did you say?
Six in total.
Six in total, sorry. My brain went a bit funny.
Yes, very good, Brandon. No, we won't be playing that dead or alive, thank you.
So one wound.
It's always one.
Stubber.
Yep.
That might do it, mate. That might raise the stakes a bit, yeah.
Fives. No wounds. Six. Nine, 12. Chain cannon. I've got one more brigand to go after this. Got five misses. Fours. Just one hit, AP2.
That's it.
Okay, last brigand.
Oh, that's a good one, Tom. Let's get that one done.
Threes. AP5. So just the damage, D6 plus four. Seven.
There's six, and that kills one.
Is that character that was with them low not?
No. But obviously...
Oh, it's part of the unit.
It's part of the unit, yeah. So you carry on to try and kill him.
So
he's no longer leading a unit now, though, so I don't get...
Two sustained?
Don't get the feel no pain off of the... Because that was off of the aberrant, but not part of what he's doing.
What's his toughness?
Three.
Threes.
You got the Avenging Fire, the chain gun yet? Have you the 12 shot thing?
No,
that's fine. I'm gonna take one.
You sure?
Yeah. You're definitely dealing with that. I forgot about the fact you hadn't got that one. Because he's not got like an armor save or whatever. Yeah. To the surprise of no one, there's no more aberrants. But what I do get to do is roll a dice now.
Oh yeah, of course.
The back.
I'll come back. Yeah.
So.
You place your blip immediately 9 inches away, yeah?
I place it anywhere I like.
Yep.
But the 9-inch thing is if you end any kind of move within 9 of it...
It removes it.
It goes away, yeah. Cool. So I'm going to put it here, I think. Mm-hmm. Just... hiding. Basically. Yeah.
Put a lot of resource into that, Callum. A lot of shots there, mate. You happy with that? Got what you wanted out of that, didn't you? No more aberrants.
Because they could drop a knight, quite high damage. In terms of other shooting, I've got three carnivores left that can shoot. They are going to put everything into gene stealers.
Okay, how far away from the gene stealers are these carnivores, please?
So this one...
Over 12, that's the main thing.
Over 12, this one, within 12, this one...
Just out?
Yeah, I'd say just out.
Okay, how many shots are we talking about?
D6 blast, so it would be D6 probably plus two.
D6 plus two.
Hitting on threes, strength five, no AP, one damage.
Yeah, I'm going to spend a CP to give them stealth and the other two cannot shoot them.
Cool.
So they can choose a different target if there is anything. I don't think there is, but...
Well, they're indirect, so...
Okay, yeah, so...
This one will go... You've got
10 block. Idiots there, yeah.
Yep, so I'll go over there.
Yep.
Plus the two, so three, so I'm hitting your fours. Three's the wound. One, no AP.
So that was one with darkness stratagem that Luke did.
We'll shoot them.
Yep.
Fours. Down to one CP, Luke?
Nothing. Two.
And the one that can shoot these.
Yep.
D6 plus two. So four, hitting you on threes. Toughness, four.
Yes, yeah, times four.
So threes?
Yep.
Just two.
Okay. Do you only get sustained against the aberrants then?
Yeah, because I didn't put it on the carnivores.
Ah, okay. They're fine with their ward saves.
Cool.
Ward saves? Playing old world.
No, I knew what you meant. Yeah.
Yeah.
What CP you want Callum to?
One. Oh, I spent one on Dreadhounds. Charles, risking. Only got 10 and a character.
Yes.
They have one wound apiece.
Two wounds.
Two wounds each.
With the invuln in combat as well.
What's the invuln?
Five up.
Okay. So we would need to get two in really. Just going to charge me next turn. So might have to trade a carnival. This carnival is going to declare a charger.
Sure.
So just 10? Measured it's a 10.
Mm-hmm.
I do get a reroll here. Is it a 10? Because I literally did it. Base to base. Yeah, a 10.
There you go.
Bit calm and relaxing.
Bit of calming background music, boys. What do you reckon? What sort of vibe do we want?
Not gonna do it. Cool. That is the end of my turn.
Okay.
So it's not very 40k this background music.
I picked up Assassinate.
Yep.
What did you get, Callum?
I've got 4 points on Assassinate.
Mentally, you've got max for that already. Assassinate. <Yeah. laughs> Unless I literally just like hide. Which also makes it hard to then actually do anything. Not very likely. Okay, cool. Right, so four. Over to me then.
Four and assassinate because it's fixed.
CPs all round.
Yeah, I got one.
I rolled two dice and any fours are another CP for me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to pick up some cards. Card number one, defend stronghold. Whoa. Card number two, behind enemy lines. Whoa.
Primary, you're on two.
Behind enemy lines and defend stronghold. And you what? Got two. What did you get in primary?
Hold one and hold two for 10 points.
So
10. On a 9-inch, am I able to get onto that objective and be outside of 9 of your guys? Or is it going to have to be a 3-inch? Looks like that's a no. Yeah, that's fine. These guys are fine where they are because you can't get your nurglings there.
Looks like you beat me on the dead or alive there, Tom, mate. You did pretty cheeky. Because I'm assuming she's... What? She's alive, right?
Make the charge a little bit more difficult.
Don't let me Google it. Reveal. Viking veteran played versus 13 Chaos Baby Knights using the new Dark Elder detachment. Table then by turn 3. Crikey, lad. What are we taking? I'm telling you what more snooker voice. It sort of fits these two. These two are quite like chill, very relaxed. They both seem very calm. They could be snooker players, couldn't they, these two? I think a couple of snooker players. Cam, you've been getting some compliments, looking like a strong lad.
You're sticky.
I don't know how well received that is with you, but I'm just passing it on. I mean, it's not words, not my words.
When does the sticky objectives disappear?
At the end of a turn, I believe.
End of a turn in which I control it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Jesus, do you know what, Tom? You and Liam need to start your own show where you can get all these oldies and just have a look at them. I had a real good search the other day when Liam was on about how much he thought Debbie McGee was attractive. I was so hoping she would be on Cameo because I would pay for her to give Liam a message, but she's got too much class. She wouldn't lower herself to that, would she?
Okay. I'm going to advance the Gene Sealers so I can advance and charge. Movement 8, so they've got 12-inch.
Oh, here they come. Here come the Genie boys. In the Ugandan church camp.
The other side of the wall, just like there. And then we'll get his mate here. There. And then the rest, I'm just going to kind of
OC here, Luke?
They're one each. What's the OC of your knights?
Eight each.
Eight each. But the sticky objective.
Yes. If you control it at the end of your turn, you'll take it off.
But even with just one gene stealer?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. I thought you were going to tell me the OC of the OC of eight was coming to play even off of that. Sticky objective.
I may have something on my sleeve, but
oh gosh, what is it?
Well, I'll tell you when I do it.
Oh no! Oh no!
So everything here is a walker, which opens up a strat.
Everything here is a walker.
At the end of your charge phase.
Oh, what's he going to do, chap?
Oh, what, heroic intervention?
Yeah.
I hope my plan is to hopefully. I can tag both of these, hopefully, if I get enough of a charge move.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if this one would be able to heroic through his own unit. Or no. 6 inches wouldn't be enough to get on the objective anyway. But yeah, no, heroic intervention, I'm hoping to work around just by charging. I don't want to tag multiple because you'll stomp them. I mean, how many attack? Are they good in combat, these shooty ones?
This is your regular reminder to please ensure you like and subscribe the video and get involved in all the streams that we do. We do Monday podcast, Met Monday, and the live streams are back every Thursday. We're going to do the Epic Flail Invitational Knockout event. Thanks to everyone that supports the show. We appreciate your loads.
And you've got...
And you've now got some theme music, look.
Okay. This boy is just going to die. He stays there. Hang on a minute.
Who is that one guy? Who is that? Sat on his lonesome.
12 inches up.
Very, very good. Dead or Alive coming in again from Tom Green. DMX, Dead or Alive. Poll coming up. Place your bets.
Need to get a good charge.
I've got this.
Feel like one of those, guys that runs fair rides, you know what I mean? Don't have a horse going in. Place your bets, please. Place your bets. 2 minutes. We'll kick them off in 2 minutes. Get to your chairs, ladies. Get to your chairs.
These guys.
Paul, put the Venger Boys on. Mate, I've been Googling copyright free, so I don't think Venger Boys are copyright free.
Actually, just...
Oh, they've got some tunes.
B in there, is there? So, I think what he'll do is just... Yeah, back of his base is there, not the front. We'll just go like that, just to sort of make it slightly harder for you to get him, maybe. This is fine. This is... How far away from that?
His music will never die, George. Never die. Simon, thanks for asking us questions. I haven't mentioned it yet. Well, I have actually. I've mentioned it about five times. The Gene Stealers are revolting. Absolutely revolting. They are not converted into sloths. They are sort of like evil. I mean, Luke's done an amazing job of them, to be honest. But yeah, they're sort of like furry.
6 inches.
Luke's whole army is super cool. Looks great. All converted Skaven.
Within eight of that, which is nice.
Dead or Alive, Keith Chegwin.
Sorry, we're just...
You haven't got... I think I'll ask you this already, sorry. You haven't got a 3-inch deep strike with your Nurglings, have you?
No.
Okay, so they're fine where they are. Oh, they're Nurglings anyway, so they couldn't take that from me.
Yeah, they're zero, I see.
Yeah. So really, I just need to actually... Just come back a little bit to deny the charge from that.
Place your bets, dead or alive, DMX, dead or alive.
Just to prevent them getting the charge. Right, so that's that. This is probably fine where it is. So, reserves.
That's so big.
For a 3-inch?
For a 3-inch charge, a 3-inch deep strike.
How are you feeling this is going, Callum? Share your thoughts, my friend, while Luke disappears under the table for the first time.
Yeah, I think it's going okay. I mean, the scores was... What's it? It's only been
14-25.
Yeah.
You happy?
Yeah. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, spotted a few gaps around the board.
There's some shouts. People say in the chat, get the bombs out, Luke.
Get the bombs out.
Get your bombs out. Here they come.
Toby, the answer is she's rebooting. It's a good dead or alive. This one, Tom, we got 9 votes in, guys. Get your votes in on DMX, dead or alive. 44% saying dead, 56% alive. Callum, what do you reckon? DMX, dead or alive?
He's what?
He's dead.
You don't say it with so much conviction because you spoiled the game.
Nine inches there. Just hemming that thing in.
Matt, don't pretend you don't know DMXs. You absolutely love DMX. I know you got posters when you were a kid and all sorts. Not sure about this music that's come on. Sorry, everyone.
So hopefully they go away. That one's going to struggle to get over to here. Yeah, do this 3-inch thing first. So I've got demo charging boys here.
It's always a bit you worry about with the Genestealer turn when everything starts coming down with those demo charges. Brandon, be best behaviour. Dead or murdered Princess Diana. That is not the game. Don't take us down that road, Brandon. Brandon, no.
What I might do is just put a demo charger there.
Yeah, that is the right question, George. What's Lancashire, eh?
And then... that's got 2 uses of the strat. So that should only need 1 demo charger. Fine. So then he'll sit. Of course, I've got 3 demo charges pointed there, 1 demo charge pointed there.
Mm-hmm.
So that's them down, and then I've got some neophytes to come down as well, which I'm just contemplating how I want to move them. So if I was to put neophytes down over here, 9 away from that guy, my question to you is, can I position them in such a way that's going to deny this one from getting here to deploy servo skulls?
Yeah, if you put like 1 here, 1 here, basically the same line you had with the aberrants.
Okay, so I could put some neophytes there.
Yeah, you've got a gap here.
Okay, and that could prevent him from getting servo skulls. Then it's just wondering on here what to do. So I don't think I'll be able to strike, I don't think I can do, because I'll go to there, so then you're well within 6 if you wanted to do it
mm-hmm.
with 1 of the 2 carnivores,
yep.
But you'd struggle. You wouldn't be able to do it with that dude there. Is that right?
No, I don't think so.
Yeah, just out.
Yeah, yeah.
So if I do that, it means that one of those is going to potentially have to do that if you want the points for it, which might be worthwhile. So I'm going to deploy some neophytes as well. So these have all got grenade launchers. So I'm just going to do it relatively sweet.
Yeah,
so just,
no, we're 9 and 9.
Yeah, just shout if you think you spot anything ridiculous.
I'm worried.
Now you start.
Sorry.
And then...
okay, DMX poll will shortly be closing. You have 30 seconds. DMX, dead or alive? 60% saying alive.
I don't think I can put these to stop you hitting that objective. I think Is that right? I think that's right, isn't it? Annoyingly.
You mean hitting it just to control it, or?
So if you charged, you're going to make it on that objective.
Yeah.
Because I have to go there, don't I?
Yeah.
I'll be
up.
I'd like to have been able to do that, but I can't. So yeah, they're going to go there. The big guns and grenade launchers. Sort of there, Primus. Okay, just kind of trying to limit your options a little bit, really. Mm-hmm. Stretch you to do multiple things. So they're down. The shooting phase. So mm-hmm. I'm going to spend, so if I spend 1, 2 for that, that's going to go probably to 1.
You spend CP, Luke, that's
it. Yeah, I'm just thinking how I want to do it.
What do you reckon, guys? The suitcase boys have all come down with them bombs ready at Wonder Armour.
That's fine. I'm going to spend 1 CP, Paul.
Yeah.
To give the... what are they called? Acolytes grenades.
Okay.
Use grenade stratagem on this unit here.
Mm-hmm.
So, 2, 4... Six.
So that unit, I just put in camera that he's putting the grenade strat on.
So 3 mortal wounds.
I have 9 left.
And then he's going to do the same thing on here.
Yep.
So he's got the ability to do it for free.
Yep.
1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'm going to spend the Nexus's 0 CP ability to give that unit +1 ballistic skill, +1 AP.
Cool.
And I'm going to give for another CP. Yeah. I'm going to spend 2 CP to give this unit +1 to wound.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, I've got to do it at the start shooting phase. I thought I didn't have enough CP, but I'm only spending 1 on grenades. So forgetting that's free.
Mm-hmm.
So this unit gets +1 to wound against 1 target,
yep.
Provided it's 2 things shoot at it. So I'm going to fire this at that and yep. them at that.
Yeah, that's
that
cool.
Gives them +1 to wound. So I've got a 0 CP. So this Ridge Runner is going to fire at that.
Mm-hmm.
So D6 shots +3, so 4 shots. I hit you once. And I am strength 6, so that's nothing.
Mm.
But that now has an extra AP
yeah.
for all the other shots.
Seeing up those briefcases.
Unit here. And I have 4 seismic cannons, which are...
the cups are coming out.
Cups coming out.
Come the cups, boys!
I love a loot cup.
So there are 4 shots with rapid fire 2. So it's 16 and then another... 2, 4, 6, 8, so 24.
Yep.
So got capo 24. So they get 4 rerolls to hit, sustained hits. 4 rerolls come from the primus in the unit.
Mm-hmm.
They hit on 5s, but with 4 rerolls.
Yep.
And they got +1 to wound. And that's blah blah, and they ignore cover as well for what that's worth.
A bunch of sustain in there as well.
That was a bunch of sustain. That's very, very good.
What's this unit again, Luke?
So the neophytes with the seismic cannons in the middle of the board, shooting at the nearest carnivore. Is it carnivore?
Yes.
Yeah, the nearest carnivore. So take that many out, and then it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 back in. So 3, 6, 9. 11, and their strength.
It's the old seismic ticklers.
So, 5s. Oh, you get +1 to wound, right?
With +1, yeah, 4. So 4. So, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14.
Yeah.
is one.
Smooth camera work there for me, guys.
Off of the, whatchamacallit, seismic cannon is AP1 normally, yeah. So AP2 total now.
Cool. So the whole unit can't see me? Because you've got guys inside the building, right?
That is true, but on the turn they're coming down, I get ignores cover.
Oh, okay, cool. So AP2, so we're looking for fives.
Yep.
What's the damage?
D3.
6.
4, 5, 6. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12.
Oh, done it by one.
Oh.
Do I explode? No.
And then we got these boyos.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to fire the unit here. So one demo charge into this, first of all. So
I'm worried.
2 plus 3 is 5.
Good Marcelo.
Thank you. four pass. Rolls to hit. Needing 4s instead of 5s. Normally it'd be 5s, but then 2 sustained for this many hits. Their strength 12.
So 3s.
3s, and I get to reroll 1 because you're on an objective. So these are AP2 normally going to AP3 because of my strap.
5 off Binvon. Binvon. What's the damage on these?
2 each.
2 each. Have you got any more to come out of this model?
So this is just the one demo charge here at that one.
Okay.
Because I'm going to do this section here and then this section here. Sorry, I should have been clear on that.
So one demo charge here.
One demo charge went there.
Okay, and they're 2 each.
And they're 2 each.
I'll save.
And I've got some hand flamers here on there. To come now, and then it'll be the rest of the demo charges I'll resolve here in a second. So, 1, 2, 3 hand flamers. 2.
Jesus Christ, lads, I just accidentally pasted Tupac's death in Dice Saloon chat rather than a link to the stream. You don't believe me, look at this.
Oh, these will be AP... Oh, sorry, I would shoot this at them as well.
To get the
extra AP. I haven't done that yet.
This is me trying to get more people to watch the stream. I've just posted 9th of April 2021, age 50. In the entire Dice Saloon chat.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
You have 5s because you can't see me?
4.
Let's try that again, shall we?
Nope, that's fine. I just need to hit you to get that effect. This guy's got his other gun, 24-inch D6 shots. So 4, 2, 3. He hits on 3s because he is in the open.
Apparently not.
strength 5, so 1 save. AP1.
Strength 5?
Yeah.
210.
No save. Got two crappy pistols here. They both hit, one sustained, need 6s, nope. And then we've got 3 demo charges on this guy. So 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, add 9, so 18. On him.
What's the AP on this?
So this is gonna be AP3.
And damage is D3?
Damage is 2.
2.
Strength 12, rerolling ones to wound and rerolling all hits.
And you rolled 9.
But then I get another +3 per, so it's 18 total.
Okay, yeah, don't worry. I was going to put a 4 up in vinyl.
Okay. No, fair enough. So 4s, that was a 4, that one. And then 4 reroll. And then 1, 2, 3, 4 with the system.
Fans of the Meta Monday show, anybody else worried about Peter?
Yeah.
We've not seen him for over a week now.
So.
Peter, where are you?
6, 8. -3.
On a serious note, though, thoughts and prayers to Peter. We hope he's all right out there in the old Ukraine.
Have you got any more shooting to come?
Got
from
some
that
flamers.
And Brandon, I've just seen the flail discard. Thanks for the Mr. Bean meme, staring at the watch, and sorry about the slight delay to kick things off. I do appreciate you waiting. People that are listening, if you don't normally tune into the show, check out our Discord. Make sorry. Tom, no.
And a flamer, one hit. Oopsie daisy. Wounds, unless you want me to roll it in the tray.
No, that's fine.
Actually, no, strength three, so that would be a fail.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's everything. Charges. Mm. I'm going to charge just this one.
Yep.
See how far I go.
I shouldn't have spent that super.
Did you spend one, mate? What are
your
left? One left, Callum.
I've got one left, yeah.
Five. So I have to come around to your side.
Hey, oh, here he is.
Here he is. It's 2 CP, isn't it, heroic? That's why you're...
Yeah.
That's suddenly you're just thinking. So as long as I'm out of an inch now. And the only difference would be I could have charged the other one. I mean, I guess I would have just about made it, I think, anyway. So I don't think it would have made the hugest difference because I just tagged them both.
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm actually going to do, because those two are already on the objective, I'm just going to... move ones that Patriarch can go there. Guy's gonna go there. He'll go in there.
I think you win the dead or alive there, Tom, with DMX, mate.
No.
Strong, very, very strong dead or alive performance. Huh?
So what I'm going to do now is just...
You got 60%, trick 60%.
I'm going to move to him to there. Move him to there. Go around there, he'll go around there. He'll just move a little bit like that. And then... just need to keep him on the objective, basically. Mm-hmm. So that's that. So then pre-combat piling.
I'm wondering if it's worth overwatching. Do I need CPs for anything else?
Callum's just burning his clock here. Luke hadn't realised it. It's a Callum play. Look at this, one of his high level plays he's learnt.
What's your attack profile here?
Four attacks each. Bench four.
Yeah.
I hit you on twos. But basically, against a unit like that, it's fishing for dev wounds.
Yeah.
Because sixes are dev wounds because of the Patriarch. Okay.
That's fine. I'll leave the Overwatch.
Okay. And you got four attacks coming back, is that right?
Did you say?
Yeah. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to... pile him with this one like that. Mm-hmm. And tag him. He's just going to go in there, and then the guy that's here, he's just going to do the same.
Yep. And tag this back one. Yeah?
Tag the back one as well. Yeah, thank you.
Oh, that feels so weird.
Yeah.
I'm picking up a caterpillar.
In fact, I hate caterpillars. That's why I'm trying to report
it. That one at the back, going at the back one.
Yep. I am going to put a 6 up, feel no pain on this one here.
No.
Matt, Luke is on 39 minutes and Callum is on an hour.
We'll have to take a battle shot test. I'm not going to make you do it unless it's actually going to be relevant.
The legion. And it means I won't be able to spend that strat.
Okay, yeah, so do the battle shot test for him then, see if it...
So, on this one, it's fine. On the one at the back, it's fine. On the one here, it's fine.
Cool. And then 2, 4, so is it 9 gene stealers times 4, 36.
Just going into the middle one.
Yeah, so everyone, so he can go into both. that one at the back, I just resolved against the back one.
Yep.
And I've just realised now I've got to take another four out because that guy's not in base to contact with anyone. So it will be eight gene stealers into that front one. Mm-hmm. So eight fours are 32. Oops. And then strength four.
So what faction do you play, George, mate? What do you rock?
Mm-hmm. Only one damage though, so
wow.
Two.
Holy what?
Two dev wounds.
Two dev wounds.
Wound on sixes though.
Oh fine.
Yeah, yeah.
So I got my six up, feel no pain.
Yeah.
Match your two sixes now, I guess.
Yes.
I've got one.
Yeah.
So one wound.
Yes. Can I just realise something? If it's all right with you, I just want to double check that I'm behind enemy lines. Because if I'm not, I won't tag this guy. I'll bring them back more around there if that's all right.
That you won't have the whole unit behind. Yeah, you won't be able to get the whole unit.
That's fine. So what I'll do then is I'll just scooch these around more, leaving this guy out, so that then I've got as many there as base contact as possible.
Mm-hmm.
And then the ones at the front are going, will go that way, then the ones at the back wouldn't have had enough to get it there. They'll just pile in sort of like that way.
Cool.
And then pre-combat, they'll go in here. And then, so I'll have to do that with him first then instead, wouldn't I? So he goes there.
Yep.
And then that goes.
So you just need to make sure you still have the same amount in contact with the attack you just rolled, yeah?
To be honest with you, if I did any damage, just take it off, have the wound back, mate, because I rolled so badly.
You sure?
Yeah. Because the objective here is not to do any damage to you anyway, so I'm not too precious about that.
Mm-hmm.
It's just making sure that I can actually get in there. So are they all in there now?
Yeah, I'd say so.
Perfect. Cool.
You're very warm.
I've got the windows open.
No, that's all right. It's just me, I get very warm. And then, yeah, so your attack's back on the two.
So I'll go with the front. Well, I'll do them both at the same time, same profile.
George, people that play AdMate, they're an interesting bunch, aren't they, mate? So, you know what I mean? You have to have cash to play AdMate properly. You've got to have cash. I respect anybody who's tried to make the journey.
Three, no AP.
One takes a wound. Cool. So, end of my turn, I get behind enemy lines. For how many is that? Four?
3 points.
3 points.
Behind enemy lines.
Defense stronghold, I presume you're keeping.
I'll keep it, yeah.
Yeah, because it takes place in your next command phase anyway.
Yes. And then it'll be your go.
Cool. So I currently, what's your AC here?
So they're battle lines, so two each.
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. This guy's
on there as well. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Possibly because you can see there the shadow.
Yeah, 16.
16. And then on here, 18 maybe.
Yeah, so you do out.
And then another one here.
So you flip that as well. Deny me primary, that's
denied.
What did you get on primary, mate?
Me? Nothing. Luke just outdone me on OC. It's fine.
Even though I fluffed all the bloody...
Yeah.
So, let's have a look at the board while the boys, Callum, has wandered around the board. So that's the objective that Luke managed to hold primary on there, just beating Callum to it. And we've got... Oh, the Ugandan churchcomer's getting upset there, sorry. There's gene stealers right in Callum's back line on his home objective, his back objective. Fabian, first time here, don't get anything. Mate, you get nothing but fun, joy and laughter from the some of the games we're playing in this chat, mate. You're going to absolutely love yourself. Stick around, like, subscribe. Then we've got more of those knights in that back corner. But this is only Callum's second turn, so we'll see what he's going to do. Luke, how did you feel that went, my friend? You happy with that turn?
Mixed bag. Did well on the mission, but on the primary. Would have hoping to take out three knights there, but just shy on the invuln saves. Callum rolled particularly well on the shooty knight here. with the invuns. But that's the greed, that's the thing, you know, you split fire like that, you're not always guaranteed to kill them. So
true.
I was hopeful with, you know, two grenade strats and the demo charges, they'd be alright, but.
And how are you feeling for time, Luke? You're about 35 minutes, I think.
Yeah, right. It's not ideal. We'll see. Need Callum to kill some stuff, and then I'll have less.
Bring
less
it back, yeah.
Move, yeah.
Fabian, what do you want on your first visit to this channel, mate? What's the expectation? We'll see what we can do, mate. You know what I mean? We'll see what we can do.
Oh, excuse me, mate.
Callum apparently will be removed from the team if he loses. No pressure, Callum.
Shut up, Toby.
I'm only playing, mate. Let me just wind you up.
Or is that George?
You're right the second time.
I need to prepare them, to be fair. They're T4, 2 wounds each. Run up in. Any invuln?
5 up invuln.
Against melee or?
Yeah, all the time.
All the time.
All the time, yeah.
It's fine. Shoot to here.
Yeah, nice stuff. Maybe that's it, mate. You've won a Land Raider. Thanks for randomly joining the show.
Inch. 13. Have you got any, like, demo charges or anything like that?
No demo charges, no.
Nothing vicious like that?
No, nothing vicious like that. And now, any shooting is going to be significantly worse.
Because you use the demo charges over there?
Well, I've used the demo. I've got 4 hazardous tests over here as well. One died, but what I'll do is I'll take the one not on the objective.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, this one not on the objective. Basically, I'm not getting sustained hits there anymore, and I don't have the +1 to wound you there anymore. Cool. So that thing that I did with the seismic cannons is not going to be as likely. Yes. Especially if you're Overwatch. Yes.
It's
Overwatch.
It's only when you pop up, isn't it, essentially? So, yeah.
Yeah, the sustained hits. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Great question, Telly. Is it okay to call a pet cat Lictor? Vote now.
This lot.
Our streaming game's really come on in the 3-month break we've had. Not only the cameras all improved, but the polling, I think the chat interaction on the polling's stepped it up. Well done. Well done, team.
I get CP, yay. Did you roll for your CP, by the way?
No, because I didn't control it. I didn't go up on there.
Oh, have you got control on objective?
Your home objective, yeah.
Oh, okay.
CP, what are we on, sorry?
Two.
Two and three, Luke?
One.
Oh,
so spent loads. Did you use it for the feel no pain then, last turn?
Yeah.
So you should be on one again now, because you went from 2 to 1, that's why you couldn't do the heroic. And then you used the feel no pain.
Okay, 2 and 1.
I took my wounds back, didn't I? Because we messed about here.
Yeah. Because like I said, I just don't worry about resolving the attacks, but you'd pop the strat before I do the attacks, right?
Yes, yeah.
But I guess I'd have less models in now, so would you have done the strat?
Should we roll for it? 1, 2, 3, I did. 4, 5, 6, didn't
I? Yeah, that sounds fair, yeah.
So I didn't. So yep. I got to do.
Happy days.
It's early. Oh well, done. I didn't actually click. That's where you would see.
Hello.
Oh dear.
Yep, that comment is definitely not getting read out. But thank you, Matt, for the contribution.
On your next turn, I can potentially heal. Is he going to do much in melee?
I mean, it's possible because they've got a Primus there who's got 5 attacks hitting on 2s, 4 rerolls, 5s to wound you, 6s to wound you. It's strength 5.
Mm-hmm.
But
they dev wound you or
anything? No, it's just there's the rerolls to hit, Yeah. There's a lot of attacks in that unit. Mm-hmm. They're only strength 4, but there's a lot of attacks. They're like 3 attacks each.
Okay.
Extra arms and stuff.
I'm up for any suggestions in the chat on Meta Monday discussion. I've regretted our AI one. It was probably a bit too... It was my idea. It was probably a bit too rando. I thought about obviously doing the normal Meta Monday chat. As always, looking at the results and the score tournament results from the weekend. But also, like, a bit of a worst jobs in 40k. Worst and best jobs in 40k universe, and then comparing them to real-life jobs, see if we can any matches. Or is that as random and bizarre as the AI one? Feedback and thoughts, very welcome.
Okay, 11-inch charge, but I think I might have to try and clear some space back there, to be fair. I can spend a CP.
Brandon, that's excellent. I'll read that out in a minute. I found 2 vegans stuck in a phone booth the other day. At least I think they were vegans. They kept shouting, "Let us leave."
My base to hit.
Cool.
And you probably get.
Oh, mate, Toby, you're an absolute G today. Just pure star. I like it. Press ganging people in. Legend.
Shooting. Let's go with this brigand here. Put everything into this unit. Go with the stubber first. How many characters you got in there? 2 or 3?
In this unit, it's 2 characters here.
Okay. Are these 2 different units?
Yeah, this guy on his own.
Okay.
He's the lone op guy.
Okay. I'm within 12 anyway.
Oh, yeah, if you are, that's fine. I'm going to... I'm going to do my mortal wound thing. So if you end a move within 12, so I'm assuming if you want to shoot him, you're going to do that. If you don't want, basically on a 2 plus, he's going to take 3 plus D3 mortal wounds.
Cool.
So it does take them, and then it's going to be 5 mortal wounds.
7 left. Is that a single
use?
So
this guy's got it as well. I don't think this guy was in 12 though. So
this wounded one will shoot here first.
Okay, he's -1 to him because he's got stealth.
Yeah, he's a -1 anyway because he's bracketed now.
Nice.
Unless it affects my ballistic skill?
No, it's just -1. This is a smart way of doing it.
Okay, so rapid fire and stubber first. So hitting you on 3s. You are the closest, so we'll be getting the AP bonus. Strength 5, toughness 3?
3, yep.
3s. So 4 AP 2, AP 1.
He takes 3 wounds, which I think is enough to kill him.
Or is he not attached to the unit?
No, he's literally on his own.
Oh, okay. I thought that was a unit.
No, he's the lone op, and then these two are attached to the... Because he was the one that ran up here on his own, if you remember.
Okay, right.
Towing on. He's only got 3 wounds. So he's dead.
Cool. Sorry, I thought he was attached.
If you want to split something else up, then fine.
I'll put the rest of the stuff into here.
Yeah, fine.
So melter, 1 hit, 2s, 1 at AP5.
AP5?
Yeah. For 9 damage on 1 rat.
See you later.
10 and 12, and then the chain cannon. T3, yeah?
Yep.
So 2s.
Oh no, sorry, these are T4.
So 3s. 6 at AP2.
So that's 4 die. So 4 die, and I've got 2 6 up saves because they're cover. Another 2 die. Let's take you.
Oh, we've got a very... So a Dead or Alive direct challenge from Tom Green, Dead or Alive champion, direct to George, and only George. Excellent Dead or Alive. John Fashion You, Dead or Alive. George only. See if you can respond. Say you don't Google it, George, either. We need a quick response, actually.
Three at AP one, because he's no longer eligible to him.
Okay, AP one, so get their five ups because of cover, so two die.
Ten and 12. Chain cannon next. Winning you on twos, unless I got a minus.
No.
Three, six.
Okay, he's coming dead. John Fashion You. George has gone for dead. Let's find out.
Got three that are on the cover. No. And then four.
And then two melters that he's going to fire from when they were still visible.
Cool.
Twos.
Who's
AP5, two AP5.
How many is it?
Two.
As a team, there were times we were 100%, 120, no, let's not, 200% physical. Boom. What were we like to play against as a team? I would just tell you, we were hellfire. We were your worst weekend. Adam, what is too far? There was no such thing as too far, Adam.
Threes to threes. Just the one. No AP.
No AP on this unit. So four up. Nope.
These two brigands will put everything into the gene stealers. I will just do these at the same time because they're the same profile.
Oops. Sorry.
That's all right. Six. Two, four, six, eight, ten, and 12. So two stubbers. I'll be hitting you on threes now because I'm engaged. Toughness four. So threes. For else. Three, six, nine at AP one.
On this unit still?
No, this is these two who are locked in combat into the gene stealers.
Oh, of course, sorry, yeah. You did your minus one, yeah?
Yes.
Yeah. Nine. Two, four, yes. Four, six, eight, nine. And one damage each, you say?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Minus one.
Minus one. So it's basically invuns. I don't have an armor save that I'm aware of. That's any better.
Right, Tom, don't be taking people off the stream to go play Helldivers with you. Only when the stream's finished, please. But I'm up for a game after.
And then another one, two, and one left on a wound. So take three away, and one's left on a wound. One, two.
I'm going to fire two chain cannons.
Yep.
Two separate units. Hitting you on threes instead of twos.
Oh, sorry. End of your movement phase. The aberrants come back.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll just do that here before I forget.
Aberrants are coming back, boys. Brandon, don't be going when the stream's on.
I'll just tidy them up in a bit.
Threes to wound you. Three, six, nine, 12 AP2.
12 AP2? Six, eight, 10, 12.
One damage apiece.
So one's on a wound, so one is dead, and then one, two, three, four more. Which ones are just shot?
These two.
Those two, so he still has
four melters from them as well.
Okay. You've got the objective at this point. So 1, 2, 3.
We're in the wrong.
And that one. 1, 2, 3. No, there's one more as well. So I'll take you. Cool.
3's to hit you.
Missed you once.
2's to wound you. Wounded you twice. Oh, that's annoying. 3 models left. I've only wounded you twice. Oh. AP5.
AP5?
Yeah.
So I'll do this one. So how many damage? It's going to be at least 2 damage, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because you get, okay, so yeah, and then the other one is fine. So we'll chuck the one that's tagging that one because I don't think I can take the. Could I take the other one off and you'd be in? I don't think I'll be in coherency then. So you can charge if you want, take him out of combat.
Okay, other shooting. I'll go with the huntsman here. Stubber into that unit at the front.
Yep.
3. And 3s. 3 at no AP.
5s.
You've got left there. 3, 6, 8. Fire the melter. 2s. 2 at AP4. And he's engaged. Don't really want to.
No, keep shooting.
Can't get a line there.
Keep shooting.
You want to wipe the unit out, is that what
you're saying? No, I want to charge him so I can get the objective. Oh. Am I over your base there?
No.
No, okay. Can't see that. So, this brigand's not going to shoot. Charges. The stalker here is going to charge. Yeah. 8.
Oh, Paul, someone's gifted me a flail membership.
They have, yeah, totally. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Oh, well. You're a good lad.
Much obliged.
Carnival here will charge you.
Yeah, of course, yeah. So.
10.
Moonwalking either then. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Carnival here will charge here.
Oh.
Oh, that one.
Oh. Oh.
We'll
I'm
still do it.
It's
don't
that
get promise. Too excited.
Yeah, yeah. It's, no, I was annoyed at myself because I thought about it earlier. Obviously, you could see me taking the ones here.
Yeah.
Because I put him there and not like back here.
Yeah.
I could never have taken him away, which if I put him here, I could have taken out that chunk and you that might have actually made the difference, but we live and learn.
So I am less than a 9. I would have to spend the CP
to go through the walls. Yeah.
So I'd need an 8 on a dice re-rollable. I think at this point it's probably worth trying to at least take something better. I will spend the CP on that last charge of the pack.
Yep.
Looking for an 8 on the dice, re-rollable.
Yep.
I'm not going to use them again.
Oh.
Failed charge. Cool. I will go with... How many wounds on these characters?
He's got 3, he's got 4, and that guy's just got 1.
Cool. So I'm going to go with big attacks. So hitting you on 2s.
Okay.
Winning you on 2s.
Is this that combat down by the dice tray?
This one here, yeah. So these are AP3.
So you squish him,
mm-hmm.
which is a wound. And then on the Nexos, how much damage do they do?
D6 plus 2 each.
Plus 2, so you'll kill him. So that's so I've got 3 left, right? So he's got a refractor field, effectively. So 5 up in vans. So 2 go through, which it'll be enough because it's going to be the 4 we get.
Yeah.
It'll be that much.
Yeah, 13 damage.
Yeah, just the 13. Cool. So that's that.
This character here.
Oh, I roll a dice for this unit. They do not come back.
Cool. This character here, any invuln or anything like that? How many wounds?
He's the same as that guy you just smushed. Okay. 4 wounds, 5 up refractor field. Yeah, 4 wounds.
Don't usually sweep with carnivores.
Your toughness less than 4, right?
Toughness 3, yeah.
Yeah, so it'd be 2s followed by 2s, 12 attacks, AP 2.
Are they 2 damage or?
1 damage.
1 damage. It's frustrating.
Or the other guy, the infantry are.
5 up save.
But they're 1 wound apiece.
1 wound apiece, yeah. OC 2.
And the character's 4 wounds?
4 wounds.
I'm just going to go big attacks.
Yeah.
2s. 2s. 5 again.
1, 2, 3, 4. Oh. He loves it. I roll a dice for this unit. Battle round 2, so, and they're battle line, so they come back.
I'm worried.
I'll just go with my stalker. So this one, same weapon profile, but less attacks, so he's not carnivore. And I'm hitting you on 3s.
Cool, I'm going to put the blip back here again.
Yep. So I've hit you once. Rubbish. It's just going to kill a gene stealer. 2s. One at AP 3.
Just one?
Yeah.
He's fine.
It's not going to get a Genestealer. Wow. Then your attack's back.
Yay! This guy here, he's got a weird injector gun thing. Hits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bone sword attacks. Strength 5. 1. AP 2.
5. Damage?
Just 1. That's what I meant when you were working out the stuff here, like when you say if it was that guy left round, like yeah, it would have just been yeah. enough. So I was trying to be honest with that. It's random, but he can do a little bit of damage. Patriarch.
How many characters have I killed this time?
You killed 1, 2, 3. Yeah. 3 characters pull for assassinate the Callum. Patriarch's got. Often this thing dies before I get to attack with it.
It should be dead, to be fair.
Yeah. I didn't actually do his attacks into that thing the last turn. He's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 attacks, hits on 2s, twin linked, strength 6. So. That's 1 save and 1, 2, 3 dev wounds that are 2 damage each.
Oof. So I'll do the save. AP?
2.
So he makes that and then cool. 6 wounds. Which one are you going into?
I'd probably just that one out near there. That's too much.
Tom, I'd be very surprised if Viking veteran from the US knows who Debbie McGee is. But, you know, we can live in hope, maybe. Or Debbie can live in hope.
That's my turn.
Viking, welcome, mate. Appreciate you joining the stream.
And I'll just do them at the same time. That one's not engaged, is he?
Well, you could charge him in.
Yeah.
Brandon. Very good, Brandon. You absolutely joke.
So, 3s. 3s. So, 3 saves, no AP.
1 wound on that Genestealer. Do you mind popping that on there for me? Thank you.
Cool. End of my turn. Yeah, just the assassinate points.
Oh,
yeah,
I got them.
Yeah.
12, wasn't it?
I'm on 16 for assassinate.
So, regular reminders, please like the video and subscribe. The YouTube algorithm does not at all like live streams, particularly one with 40,000 live streams, which makes it difficult to get it out there. So, any likes or supports of the video will help loads with the algorithm, and appreciate everyone's watching.
Basically, where the blip was, which was here, mm-hmm. for, I've got to be wholly within three. So, I could, the furthest I can be forward is like that. So, I am just over 13 inches away. So what's that, six? So it'd be a 7-inch charge if I was to move up there. That's actually not too bad. So I might go for that actually. So they're not gonna do the uppy downy. I thought I was going to, but because he's gone a bit further forward, change my mind. Fine, so setting them up properly, that'd be like that. No, I'll move them in a minute anyway. So I go to 2 CP, roll some dice for some more CP, and I get investigate signals.
Oh, lovely.
Secure no man's land. Okay.
Did you bin off defend stronghold?
No, when do I score that?
At the start of this turn. Right in your command phase, so that would still be active now?
At the end of your opponent's turn.
Oh, is it opponent's turn?
Yeah, so, yeah, scored, so I would have scored that. Okay, cool. One. I would have scored that.
So
right.
You get number five for that in your second.
Three. And then you just drew investigate and
secure no man's land.
What did you get on primary, please, though?
Five?
Yeah. Okay. I've got it 36 to 26 to Luke so far.
Don't think I'm going to be able to zero you again, though. Right.
You only got one blip down.
Blip here.
Yeah.
It's another reason I don't want to up you down with the aberrants, because just sort of put pressure on this side of the board and make it a bit less likely you're able to get here. you brave, brave boy. We'll even face there. Look, he's investigating this little corner. That's what he's doing. Something interesting in that corner.
That carnivore's going to pinch his bum.
Right. Six. So we know it's a 7-inch charge. Luckily, my rat boys don't have to worry about going through walls. There's a lot, I think that's changed a tenth in the way the knights work now. That I can see the appeal of this army a lot more than previous.
Oh, bloody knights. Not wounded, is it? Nice.
No, well. Pour one out for bloody Imperial game. Knights.
These will need to a battle shock at minus one.
Battle shock at minus one. That's probably a fail.
So that is a fail.
Are you going to kill them?
Okay, so I am going to.
Retron is just going to move wholly within 9.
I'm going to play Terror Shades for 1 CP.
Yep.
Wait, check the clock.
What do you mean, check the clock?
Is it not on? Oh, no, sorry.
It's my go. Yeah. I was still moving and stuff, so we're all good.
No, I can switch it if you want while I'm doing this.
No, I got confused with what you said it was.
Terror Shades, I'm going to do it on Eeny, Meeny, Miny, Mo. This one. So each 4 plus you take a mortal, I regain a wound.
Yeah.
So you take 4 mortals and I go up 4 wounds to 10.
Okay, so that Gene Stiller is dead, and then 3 mortals onto the Patriarch. He's got 3 wounds left. Going to roll dice for some Genestealers now.
Sorry, that was because I thought it was your turn.
No, that's all good.
They are gone for good.
Oh, I feel disgusting.
Caterpillar Genestealers.
Hold on a second. I'm just checking something. I'm not diddling myself because I've made sure I was wholly within three of the blip.
How do you feel about that term, Callum?
I'm killing lots, which I knew I would, but then they just keep coming back. It's
yeah.
Forever.
Yeah.
I did do that, right?
And then they're not as reliable from this turn now.
Yeah. Well, the Genestealers aren't coming back. Genestealers aren't coming back.
So what is coming back?
The unit here in the middle. God, that came down to 20 guys. What else did I get? Investigate signals. Secure no man's land. Two or more objective markers in no man's land.
Mm-hmm.
Aye, aye, aye. So I'm going to have to get here, and then I have to do a 3-inch charge, 3-inch deep strike into here to claim this. So this guy is moving 6. I just want to see if he advances. What I'm going to do is just a wee bit of pre-measuring. So he's gonna advance 5. Good. So he's gonna go to here. And then this unit is just gonna chain out a little bit. Like here. Essentially. So I've got a movement of 6. That puts that to there. So you can't get Nurglings here.
No, that's cool.
To shoot my thingy down. And hopefully the aberrants will be around here as well. He's sort of here pushing you back, so you're not going to be able to deep strike to here within 9 because you'll be in range of too much stuff, is the theory. So that's that. And again, I've positioned it so there's no 3-inch onto the objective either. Oh, you can't do that, sorry. I think you're actually like a demon codex, it's not quite the same. This boyo. What on earth is he going to do that's actually useful? Not a whole lot. He's just going to fall back to here, I think.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to stay an inch away from that wall, that side, and just tow him onto there. Wish he can get a little bit further, in fact, to do that there. And then we've got some acolytes. Is this 3 CP? I don't think I'm on 3 CP. Have what I am.
I've got you on 3.
Yeah, because I've got an extra one.
Have you on one that one or?
No, I spent one over here for Terror Shades.
So he's holding within 9, he's holding within 9. Have you got anything hidden back there?
No, nothing.
Okay. What I might do is just put him wholly within 9. If that's able to go within 9, that's perfect because then he'd be invisible as much as possible.
Mm-hmm. Oh wait, we've got to take the 2 inches off.
So would that be
okay? Fine.
Oh sweet, yeah. So just in that little corner there. So he's going to investigate signals, as well. And yeah, these boyos. So a CP to get down within 3 of you. Want to threaten the. Can't see that one to kill it. You're gonna get 10 primary, it's so frustrating. So they're gonna have to do that. That gets me that objective, and then if they come down here and kill him, that gets me another one. I'm just not gonna be able to get you off of the other two. Don't have the resources. Hey ho. Hopefully I've just done enough. With everything else. So this character, part of this unit, so I've got all of these boyos on here. Should be more or less outside of 3.
Mm-hmm.
I'll say he's not moved quite so far down, just so that you can tow on there as well. Lovely. Right, and then I'm going to spend other CP. I think that's everything there. Shooting phase, we're going to go with the guy here who's, he advanced, so he's not doing it. He's investigating signals. I would fire these, but they're both investigating signals, so I'm just going to go straight to spending a CP to give this unit plus one AP, plus one ballistic skill. Everything into
the
that.
Carnivore, yeah.
Into the carnivore. Yeah, everything in there. So 2, 3, 4.
I got demo chargers, didn't they?
Yeah, demo chargers.
The 2 damage each. Demo chargers.
Yeah, what I'm tempted to do as well is just very quickly, sorry to be a nuisance, just going to string out.
Yeah, he's got investigate signals and secure no man's land.
Tom, if you've taken everyone off to play Helldive, then we'd be so hungry. Without me as well. I've been moaning about everyone playing that game.
So 6 inches with one demo charge. I'm going to put one demo charge over here. On that guy.
Mm-hmm.
And then...
onto this one.
No, onto him.
I want a 3 range.
Yeah. And then... I'm going to put... some hand flamers. Then I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 hand flamers onto this guy.
Yep.
And then these guys are just sort of sat here instead now. 3 inches there. So I've got 3 demo charges here. Let's put another hand flamer in. Yeah. All the hand flamers there and 1 demo charge. I'm going to spend a CP. Before I start shooting, put grenades into this unit.
There, yep.
2, 4, 6. 2, 3, 4 mortal wounds.
7 left.
And yeah, did you want to rotate or anything like that? Is that what you're...
No, no.
Cool.
I'm going to CP anyway.
Oh, okay. And then we've got a demo charge here into him. So 5, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 5 normally goes to 4s because of the strat.
Yep.
With rerolls. And a good to sustain. 1, 2, 3, 4. Strength 12. Reroll 1s. 2, 4, 6, 8 minus 3 AP.
5 up in runs. 8 damage. There's on the one with the blue dice.
So. Yeah, it's all on that one. Yeah, I wanted to concentrate fire.
Explode. Two dogs down.
Didn't want to split it and risk it. I would have put all the flamers in there as well.
Yep.
Because I didn't know roll so well. Yeah. If I had one on the shots, it would have been very different. So, 3 demo charges here.
Mm-hmm.
9, 10, 11. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 11. And then I get the 3s extra. So exactly 20. Breaking out the cup.
Here it comes. Get the cup out.
20 on demo charges.
Yeah. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 back in. You're on an objective, so reroll 1s to hit as well. Sorry, wound rather. So 3s, rerolling 1s.
It's not enough 2s.
Just trying not to stay right under the camera, mate. Thank you.
No worries. 3, 6, 9, 12.
Only 12?
Only 12. Minus 3.
5s. Oh, that won't do it. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Yeah.
Do I does he blow?
Another one down.
Nope.
So it's 3 dogs so far.
And then we're going to charge here into there.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think I've got any other.
It was a seven.
Yeah. We get it.
Not a bloody hell.
Needed that.
This could be 4 dogs. Well, it's definitely going to be 4 dogs down. He's got 1 wound left.
Yeah, we'll wrap him to there. In this bit of the wall, and then a bit too close to the wall there, so he has to go like that. Another one there, and then the rest will just go as far.
Wait,
as
how many attacks did I get, and what's their strength?
3 each, strength 8.
Fives.
So, I mean, it's just hoping for weight of numbers, really.
Yeah.
And then with pile-ins, I'll be able to just wrap around so that I'm getting base to base with everyone who's base to base. So 30 attacks basically. So
green cup
this time. So no biphagus, so no lethal hits because you can't bring the characters back, so 3s are good. I don't mind picking up 3s. And then 5s. Two, three, four, five, six, minus 2.
Like, try and not lean on. No, just keep going around and just stand by.
Oh, well, right here. I see.
Minus 2.
Minus 2.
Looking for 5s. Imagine.
No.
No, it doesn't. Yeah. No. Does it explode? No.
Dog.
And then they'll just wobble into here.
Mm-hmm. 4 down, 8 to go.
Yeah. It falls a lot, still over.
They're both taking chunks out of each other's army. I mean, I appreciate the Aberrants came back, which is good, but there's the Acolyte's not coming back, is really good for you. Mm. You're going to strike first with a unit, is it? One at a time, isn't it? So
yes.
I might get to hit you back. Depends
so
how
I'll
you do.
Go with the Stalker first, because it's the only one that's meaningful. So hitting you on 3s. Winning you on 2s.
Mm-hmm.
2 at AP3.
Loves it.
I'll behave.
Mm. All right. That's 6 attacks back. You got to go on 10 wounds. I'll go with the one I've damaged already. Twin linked. 1 dev wound, 1 save.
AP on 2. 5s. Damage?
2 apiece.
So 8 wounds. I'm going to change that dice. Not that visible, is it? So then this one. 3s. Toughness, 4.
Yes.
So 3s. 2 wounds.
Oh, he takes 2. Down to 1.
1. That's it, isn't it?
Cool. Support. I've got 2, 4, 6 for 6 for investigate signals.
Mm-hmm.
And 5 VP for secure no man's land.
2. 2 for secure no. Oh, no, you've got 2 objectives, didn't you?
2 objectives, yeah.
So you've
got
11 altogether.
Yeah.
11 altogether, yeah.
22 on secondaries. I've got Luke on.
Yep.
What have you got?
I've got him on 47 total. Over to my turn. Got upper CP for the battle round. Control my home. On a 4 I could get another. Nope. I've done well on that.
You got 10 for primary?
Yes. I don't think I've gained a single CP for holding that. And that does now become sticky again.
You got 10 on primary column here?
Yeah, so 47, 36. And so my nurglings have to come down. Oh, I think. I should be able to squeeze them in there now.
How are you feeling at this point, Luke?
It could all go downhill. I just need to. I need to hold on. Like, I'm trying not to. I feel like I've been quite aggressive, but there's been a reason for it. Like, I haven't just YOLO'd. I've tried to be all about denying Callum points on his deployed teleport homers. Mm.
Can I borrow your tape quickly?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Which is why I went for the Nurglings quickly, because they're really good action monkeys.
Okay, so they're within now.
Yep. But I've done a bit of a misstep. A bit of a misstep there, really. I probably should have put the ridge runner a bit more like here. And then that would have been better at continuing to screen.
To investigate that signal.
Yeah. Well, I thought... Okay.
Yes, Telly?
Like, he's going to kill that. And then he'll be in the corner of the board a bit further away. But I don't think that's worth you now being able to score these points.
Shout out for Luke in the chat from Telly. Give Luke a shout out. Tell him his tactic videos are excellent. Plug the videos, please, Luke. They are
Oh, thank you, mate. That's very much appreciated. I'm pleased that
always
people enjoy.
Around, Paul, this way or the other way? This way, all right?
Plug the channel, Luke. Plug the channel.
Oh, sorry. I thought you were saying he was plugging. Sorry, I didn't understand quite what you were saying. Yeah. So I incursion tactics. I do basically a lot of 40k themed tactics. A little bit of hobby advice as well, kind of every so often. But the main focus is the 40k tactics. Yeah, and they've done some really, I consider them interesting. But I think they do seem to be really well received. I had a lot of positive comments on them. A lot of people liking them. A lot of people. Learning stuff for the first time. I had a couple of people commenting on there that so they didn't quite know how like charge distances worked and other bits and pieces. They picked up a lot of value from them. So well worth a little look, even if you are well versed in the rules or a new player. Like, yeah, there's a try to make it accessible and something for everyone, I guess. So go check it out, Incursion Tactics.
Good stuff, Luke. Awesome stuff.
Character here, yeah?
Yep, you've moved within 12 inches.
For people that are watching live, I'll put the channel in the description for people to check out, Incursion Tactics.
How many mortals?
And their Toby, yeah, sorry, I forget to update the round sometime.
That's right. He's just giving you the finger.
What is kind of funny about the scoreboard that I have is I got this guy on Fiverr to make the scoreboard and he just copied another channel. And I was like, oh no, it's so awkward. But now that channel has stopped making content and disappeared, so it's ours now.
Cool. Yeah.
I think I need to kill one more character to max it anyway.
You've got one on his own here.
Yep.
And then you've got one in the unit. So
cool.
And the Patriarch.
Yeah, so if I pick this one up, because you've already had behind enemy lines, haven't you? What have you had?
I have behind enemy lines, investigate signals, attempting target overwhelming force.
Yeah, you haven't had capture an enemy outpost or take my home objective yet, have you?
Not yet.
Get rid of that.
Interesting idea from Telly's just come in of us having at some point a bunch of us in Discord to commentate and chat about the game. I'm trying to think how that might work safely with knowing what some of these characters are like in terms of what to say. I'm looking at you, Brandon. Looking straight at Brandon. Could that work? That could be interesting. Let me think about the logistics. You guys think if you do that, if that's a good idea? And if you could behave, Brandon. Sorry, I don't know what this tune is.
Yeah, I finally picked up one of them after seeing you use that.
Yeah, that's not handy.
Yeah.
Here.
line of sight from that side.
Brandon, I'm not attacking you. You've got to be watched, mate. Imagine you on a Discord. Just could say anything on a live stream at any point, live, with my name on it. I'd have my own. You'd have to sign a waiver. Although, I'll tell you what I am up for doing, streaming some Helldivers. I was playing Helldivers again. All right, Selly, you make a YouTube channel and have Brandon come on and you be at his mercy. Also, Brandon loves it. He knows it's part of his idea. He's edgy. That's the thing. That's what we love about Brandon, the edge.
Yeah.
Just for any like reactive movement or.
No. He is toast.
Let's go. Inch that way. Give me 13 to play with. Eight. Five. This one is going to just peek outside here.
Hello.
So I can draw a line of sight over to here.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I thought you meant to stream it, Telly. Is that not what you mean? I thought it'd be like a live commentary feed. You mean people just coming in and chilling? Okay. Stop people chatting in the chat, but would that work? I don't know.
What have you both got on the clock, please, Luke? Could you shout it out?
26 for Callum, 16 for me.
Cool. Shooting. This brigand is going to put everything into these. I'll start with the stubber.
So you've got that unit that can shoot, this unit that can shoot.
Yep.
Can this one see?
No, I couldn't quite draw a line.
So it's only those two that can shoot?
Yeah.
I'm going to die. Crack on.
Cool. I'll open up with a stubber. Twos.
My four hazardous checks for
threes,
which I didn't do. No one died.
Three saves at minus one, because I can't see these ones.
Okay.
Died eight times in the tutorial.
Which one was shooting?
You're going to be an absolute nightmare on Helldivers, I can tell.
OC eight. 2, 4, 6, 8 equal at the moment.
After this stream, me, Telly, Brandon, Tom. Come on, four-man Helldivers team. Well, and anyone else who wants to play, it caps at four, but everybody's welcome.
Chain cannon.
I was saying early, Selly, how much you were enjoying my friendly fire incidents last night.
Two's the wound. Yeah, T3, right?
Four. These ones are four, yeah.
Threes. Six AP2.
Oh, AP2, sorry. Yep. Three, four, five, six.
And then the melter, could still see them at a time. Two hits, twos. Two AP5.
He's alive still.
Cool.
The unit, does it come back? Yes, because it's battle one. So these boyos are here at the end of your movement phase, so they exist here now.
Yep. Oh, but did they come on from the previous?
So that was the previous one, yeah. Okay, so they would have basically, but they're there like that.
Do the blips, do they not disappear when you come back? Or do you place them and they only disappear if I go on them?
So what should have technically happened was when you, end of your movement phase.
Yeah.
Yes, Tom.
Okay, and then when they die, you place another one.
And then when this unit dies, I place another one, yeah. Exactly that. Cool. So I'm now going to place another one. I just forgot to put them down.
Yeah. These are two separate characters now, correct?
Yes.
So are they both the same?
Yes, identical.
Cool. I'm going to shoot this back one with everything. I'll just fire the melters first, twos.
Oh.
Doesn't matter. Stubber.
I'll put the blip here.
Threes. Three at AB.
I got a five up. Invon.
Yeah,
that's my best save.
No AB. Oh, okay.
Yeah. It's either a five up armor or a invon. So two go through, taking two wounds, got two left.
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and 12. Chain cannon.
Who's this one shooting?
One. Yeah.
I thought you just shot. Oh no, that was that one, wasn't it? Yeah, fine.
Shrunk 6, T4 though, aren't they? Or are they three, the characters?
They might be three. Say it's three. I feel like it is three, actually. Yeah.
So, 5 AP1.
That's dead. More points for your. I think you've maxed it now, have you?
Yeah, this brigand will shoot his melters into the character here, so threes, twos, one save at AP5, Luke.
One save. Sorry, is it this? Or
this here.
I failed the invun. So
D6 plus four.
Yeah, he's got a one wound left. He did well to last as long as he did.
The Stalker, which is now freed up, will sling a Havoc Launcher over at...
Dude here, you got them.
I want to charge that one. Over at the unit at the back.
Yeah, which, again, I'll just remind you that if you do like a handful of wounds, because they are objective, they will heal 3 plus
D3. Oh, in my...
In my reinforcement step.
Right, okay.
So just a heads up, like if you're thinking of plinking a couple of wounds off... Probably better to bully a character or the aberrants because they can't heal.
I'll chuck it over here. 3 plus 2.
Yep.
Force to hit you. Strength 5, toughness 6. So it'd be fives. I get +1 to wound because you're not within 6 of a friendly. Are they -1 to wound?
Only if you're higher strength than 6 toughness. They might.
No. So it would be fours.
Cool. The armor save is fine because I've got a 5 up.
Yeah, there's no AP on this.
Yeah, cool. So they're armor.
This one will chuck a melter at this guy. Apparently, he won't.
Ooh.
Stubber as well.
Yeah, kill him with stubber fire.
Four saves. No AP.
He dies. Sink on.
There we go. Carnivore over here will lob its Havoc launchers at the Aberrants again. Probably worth checking range, actually. It's 48, I can imagine I am in, but. Yeah. Indirect. That one over there will do the same thing, so I'll just roll them at the same time.
Yeah, no worries. Who's this now, sorry?
So the two carnivores are lobbing Havoc launchers.
Oh, these guys, yeah.
I'll take that out for now because blast might come into effect.
Oh, okay, fine.
So the first one is 6.
Hello.
5s. That's one wound.
Loves it.
And then the other one again is. And fires. One wound.
Takes all. Fails the armor save. Passes through no pain.
Cool. Charges carnivore over the back.
Yep. Just like that?
Yep. Twos. Two. Strength 12. Toughness.
Strength 12. Toughness 7.
Should have said Nagling's deploying homers.
Yeah.
So threes, so one.
Wow.
AP three.
I got three up save normally, so six is...
D6 plus two for four damage.
Okay, I was almost going to pick him up, but he stays alive. I mean, I've got some...
What a whiff.
What a whiff. Some pathetic amount of attacks back. two saves.
Threes. That's the end of my turn.
Okay. So you maxed...
maxed assassinate and got four on homers.
Okay. End of your turn, I'm going to spend one CP.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, go ahead, mate.
And I'm going to put this unit into reserve.
Yep.
This battle line unit.
Got up to three CP.
Do I want to put them in reserves? They probably need to come and deal with this. Like 13 and a half inches away, so another 7-inch charge, jeez.
Oh, I was supposed to charge here as well, sorry, do you mind if I do that?
Yeah, go for it.
Put the clock back on me. 8 will do it. I'll do my attacks quick.
So you lot be going playing Eldivers without me. Just you wait, please. And Tom, is that actually your game? Is that your legit name?
Just lost the wind.
If so, yes, yeah, absolutely ridiculous.
Attack, rerolls to hit, no, two. And then his bone sword, rerolls to hit. And then strength five, so no. Okay, so I've put this unit into reserve, and I've put this unit into reserve.
Mm-hmm.
And I get 10 for primary.
Thank you.
And how many did you get for the teleport homers just now?
Four. And you need to select your missions as well.
Oh, thank you, yeah. Assassinate, capture enemy outpost. Have you got any characters?
Yeah, the Stalker.
That one?
Yeah.
Really? Okay. I go up to one CP. I get to roll one. I don't get to roll because I've taken them off. That's the negative for doing that. But hey ho. I've done pretty well most of the game for CP on that. Can't be too upset.
CP,
I'm on
one.
Three.
Right. They're going as fast as possible over there. And then these are going to reappear here, I think. Just try and blast those Nurglings to absolute paste. But I'm going to get within...
Do you not have to take them off your home objective to put them back on your home objective?
Yes. Because I wasn't sure what else... I couldn't remember off the top of my head what I had. So if I had like another get objective ones or getting further up...
Oh, I suppose it has happened in my movement phase, didn't it?
Yeah. At the end of your turn, I've got to take them off.
Yeah, yeah.
And the other thing as well is I wasn't too upset because by the virtue of them coming back down now, they're going to get sustained hits and ignores cover against your Nurgling. So there is a vague benefit to it, even though it is a bit random. They're going to go like that. So we're on that objective, but everyone's basically within 12 of those for rapid fire range on that. That there.
Right, you will need to take a battle shock on the thing over there.
Seven
at
is...
At minus one?
Well, that's probably a fail then, at minus one. Yeah, it'll be a fail.
So that fails. How many wounds you got left?
Four.
I'm going to spend a CP for Terror Shades. Two, three, four mortals.
Ba-boom! Nope.
That forced the battle shock, yeah, but the stratagem is terror shades.
This thing's just going to go six to here.
Callum, why is it called Patera Shades on my thing? That's why it's so confused.
I think.
So apparently Games Workshop want to call it Patera Shades instead of Terra Shades. It's a nice little ability.
Aberrants are just going to stay in there, I think.
The Shora Telly, I'll get a little clock, a time check, and put it in the chat now.
Right, and then this unit's going to go 3 inches on your home objective pillars. As long as I get more than 4 guys on, I'll be happy. Plop them here. Actually, that's not very clever doing that. Let's get these. So that's enough OC there. And the rest is kind of academic.
Mm-hmm.
Just flop into there. Like so. And then actually, that guy was, he moved 4-6, so even if he goes there, no, not going to get there with it. Okay, it's going to be tough to kill everything. We're going to do this guy attacking your guy.
This one there,
yep. So D6 plus 3, so 8 shots. Minus 1, and then...
Okay, that's how awful I am at reading, and some high-level dyslexia manoeuvre there. It is like that, isn't it, mate? Like the dinosaur, but I just thought it was a spelling mistake. Thanks, everyone. I'll be here all night with my awful ability to read.
No rerolls to hit this time.
Yep. AP damage.
AP is going to be 2 because of this other 3, rather, because of the strat and that and the normal AP. D3 damage. Cool. Hitting on 4s.
Spend CP for weapon bomb.
Yep. Oh, I needed that to be a lot better than it was.
You down to 0 CP,
Tyler? No, I've got 1 left.
Needed that to be better than it was. One, two, three, four. 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Minus 3. You got 4, I've been done.
What other shooting have you got? You've got like a load of pistols.
4 grenade launchers and then his laser guns.
Yeah, I'll leave it.
6. Crack grenades. Wow. And then it's basically, it's 4, 8, so it's 12, 11 rapid firing las guns, so it's 22. Look at all the sustained hits from las fire.
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 6s. 1, 2. And it will be your in gun again with the AP.
4s. Damage?
Just 1. It's the last gun. Little last pistol.
4 wounds left.
And then everything here firing there. So two seismic cannons at at short range. So that's 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. And then they get sustained. These hit on fives though. But two sustained. Strength 6 though, so I'm guessing that's
twos.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 saves. AP minus
6 is
4
go through.
4 go through.
Damage.
So the first one does 1, second one does 1, third one does 2. Fourth one does 1. Ugh.
So is that 1, 1, 2, 1?
Yeah. So, so one's left on...
Yeah, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3 wounds.
Yeah, and then I got two flamers. 6, 2, 4, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 saves.
Six wounds. 1, 1, 2, 1. So 3. He takes 3. Sorry, 1, 1, 2, 1. So one kill the base, we had 3 left, takes 3, and there's 3 remaining. So
one left on a wound?
One wound.
Yeah, and I've got this many last gunshots. Which hit that many times. Strength 3. So I'm guessing it's 3s. Strength 3?
4s.
Oh, okay. 4 saves. Goes down. That is my turn. So, Paul, could you put me as 8 for capture enemy outpost, please?
Yes.
And then I'm going to get rid of assassination. So I don't see myself getting that. So I'm back up to 1 CP at the end of my turn. And then I'm going to go to 2. It's going to go to 2 CP in Callum's go.
I'll go to 2. I don't control this anymore. Scored a 10.
Yep.
Bloody rats.
Bloody rats.
What's this? Better round 4. No. End of turn score.
What's your primary colour?
10.
So what with you? I'm just going to plink some shots at this thing. This guy's got to do his indirect.
Yeah.
So it's D6 plus 3. I mean, I'm probably not going to do anything. One save.
Fine.
Cool.
Right, these things need to go.
Been an interesting game in terms of everyone all over the battlefield. I feel like the battle lines have kind of moved around.
Yeah.
Like all sorts of stuff going on.
You've done well with your roles coming back.
Mm.
The boys coming back in.
Yeah, he has.
Every game I've
played,
you've
got fluff
then.
Yeah, yeah. It's a good point. Yeah.
Honestly, the games we played never.
It's funny you say that. I have had a string of games where I literally just get nothing, or like really late in the game, like a really insignificant unit comes back, and it's like, okay.
So that stalker is going to move up and just stay an inch, away.
How many have we got left?
4.
Tempted to overwatch you.
That is a very good point.
Do you want to not move?
Yeah.
Rewind.
Maybe it's not there, wouldn't it? Do I even need to move then? He will edge a little closer. Just get within melter range. Not that it should matter.
He got homers with something as well.
Hmm.
Got a gadget for that, haven't we?
Woo!
Happy days.
So I've got line sight there. Have these got any stupid bombs or anything? Or?
No, no. This guy does, though, if you're going to move within 12 of him, because he hasn't... Oh, no, he was the one here. I think we did... No, we did one here. No, he hasn't used his yet.
No.
We did the one there, and we did one there.
Yep, cool.
So if you go within 12 of him, he'll pop off some bombs. Don't forget, there's no...
Oh,
it's a handy little piece, isn't it, the old Uganda canton. We definitely need a soundboard for it, though, don't we? Have we got any Ugandan preacher-type soundboards? It'd be nice for that. Maybe have a little Google.
Yeah, I was thinking of consolidating after. Where's CP and am I on 2? That's my 14-inch move.
Don't forget, in the interest of full disclosure, these will be here at the end of your movement phase.
Yep.
Don't forget, I can then uppy down them. And they will have fresh demo charges.
Yep.
just don't want to... Gotcha.
Shooting. That carnivore then is going to deploy Homer.
Is he within 10? He's got within 12, yeah?
Yes.
So you've got to be wholly within?
No. No, just within.
Oh. Okay.
That's why everybody takes it on fixed.
Yeah, okay, fine. Behind enemy lines, you've got to be wholly within.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Very nice. Shooting. I'm going to open up with the Huntsman. Stabber first. Hitting on threes. Three saves. No AP.
Put on some ones in cover. One dies.
Belter. One hit. One wound. AP 4. Stalker. Havoc, 6, plus 2, 3s, toughness 3.
3, yeah. Excuse me.
3 is down to 2s, because you haven't got any friendlies nearby.
No.
4 saves, no AP.
1 dies.
12. Chain cannon. Twos. Cocked on there.
No, that's fine, mate.
2, 4, 6, 8. AP 1.
8, 3, 4. Actually, only one would have been in cover, so it's 5, really. 1. 2, 3, 4, 5.
Next brigand. 2s. Not broken, is it? No. And then followed by 3s. 6 at AP 1.
So 6s, 5 die.
Chain cannon. 2s. 3, 6, 9, 10 AP 2.
Oh dear. So 4, 5, so 4 dead. Another four dead, eight dead. I think that's the unit, right?
Yes.
Yeah, do you mind chucking in?
Is this where they come back?
Yes. So on a four. No, but actually, it wouldn't matter because it would be at the end of your next movement phase, which would be the last turn.
Okay.
So there's nothing.
So nothing can come back now?
Nothing
can
come back.
So I can kill it all.
You can kill it all now, yeah. Stays dead now. Run out of turns for them to get back.
Shooting here, Brigand.
Yep.
At the unit at the back there. Melter first. Two hits. Two wounds, AP5.
Sorry. It's the Brigand shooting this.
Brigand over here, yeah.
I'm just thinking, are you within 12? So I might just make it so you can't shoot me. You are not within 12. Because how many attacks does this thing have with the sweep?
12.
It's very likely you just kill it and consolidate onto that. Yeah, fine. Carry on. No stopping it. Carry on.
I hit you twice, wounded you twice to AP5.
Yeah, so two die from melters.
Yes.
That's cool.
6, 10, 12, 12. Chain cannon. Full house.
Mm-hmm.
Toughness 3.
Yeah.
2s.
That many.
11.
You'll just roll them for me. If you just roll that many dice, and I'll just take whatever stick, because it's probably going to be the
AP 2.
Yeah, so it's basically, I get a 6 up save. So 1, 2, 3 out of that survive, and then what's that?
6, 8.
8, that's the unit.
And you've got that lonely character there, yeah?
Hello.
Brigand here is just going to snipe that last character, 2s.
Oh, I'm going to do the mortal wound thing.
2s.
It goes off and you take 3, so you take 5 mortal wounds on that guy.
Cool.
So what have you got? That's it.
I'm at 7. And then you've got, if this hasn't got an invuln, it's dead.
It does have an invuln. No.
charges that carnivore of war at that last character at the back. A 9.
9. He wants it. Do you want me to move it for you?
I want to try and
no, you are.
Get on the middle of that objective, ideally. To hit.
I got new invuln, so I'm just going to
pick
him up.
Well, you saw how I rolled last time.
Well, I'd be surprised.
Have you seen my picture from Beachhead?
No.
My dice tray with these 6 attacks, and every one is 1.
Oh, no.
2s. Told you.
Twos again.
Twos again.
It's fine. Yeah, they got him. Now this is dead as well. Even if they could come back, they can't come back.
That is end of my turn.
So you've got homers for 4?
4 points. Oh, yeah, flip the time over to you, Luke.
Yep, I've got 5 on primary. Uppy downy, the acolytes are going to uppy downy.
You want to look?
Well, I think we should get up to that.
And then I go back up to 2.
How much time are you on, Luke?
4 minutes.
4 minutes.
So I've got bring it down and extend battle lines.
You binned off assassinate, right?
Yeah, I binned that off, yeah.
And CP, Luke?
CP?
Yeah.
2.
Thank you.
Okay. So I'm going to be able to tuck in here.
I would have consolidated closer onto the objective.
Fine.
To stop you doing that.
Ooh. So.
Yeah, my bases are big enough to stop. Stop being able to get on.
So I'm going to spend a CP to get rid of extend battle lines.
Mm-hmm.
No prisoners. Fine. So we got bring it down and no prisoners instead. So kind of have to go ham really. Take it down from four wounds. But I need to end on these objectives, otherwise I'm just gonna give away too many points on primary. Although I could just go down there, but can you just pick me up?
Don't know if you'd be able to place them.
3 inches. You'd be surprised. Just hitting this little nook here.
Oh yeah, I suppose.
The issue is, even if I get lucky, well, I don't mean lucky, even if I do well, pop that, you're just going to drill them. Absolutely yeah. Drill that unit to death.
Yeah.
So that feels like a stupid thing to do. So I think I have to put as much OC onto here. Well, I'll do it in a minute. That's kind of mentally where they're going to go. Mm-hmm. The rest of my actual movement. Because I think you've kind of... Need a good advance roll there to get on that objective as well. So how far away am I from that? Just shuffle that there.
15.
So what's that? 6. So it'd be a 9. 9 inches. Or 8 to be within engagement range. Which I don't think is worth gambling, to be brutally honest. I would much rather just hide. I mean, you can shoot the... You've got 2 brigands that you could maybe bring round.
Might be able to get a line here with the 4th brigand. I've got a huntsman here as well.
Yeah.
Havocs from the carnivores.
I'm just going to sit here, basically. Tuck in. If you can get a line, you can get a line, but I just need to get as much OC on there as possible. Yeah, so they're going to go there and do that. That's fine. 7 wounds, whatever. Fine. So, and then they'll plop down there, and I'll basically position them so that the ones that are within 6 could be within 6, and then that's it. And then if I know I'm just about to time out with 45 seconds, Paul, but
yeah.
All I've got to do basically in my turn is just resolve that unit of acolytes shooting, and then that's it.
Cool.
So I'm just going to quickly do that. 2, 4 demo charges, so 4, 8, 12, 13.
Oh, spend CP 6. For the 4 up in front.
Yep, 12. So 20, 13 add 12, it's 25. And I'll spend a CP to plus 1 AP and blitzing skill.
Yep.
So, So I get to reroll once because I'm Acolyte. And then I get 1, 2, 3 sustained. Strength 12. No real ones because you're not on an objective. So.
All right, Ali Delta lad. So I had my head down there.
10.
So updating the skill.
2 damage per.
Looking for 4s.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's not good.
Oh, got him.
Wow. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18 damage. Doesn't matter if I explode. That's frustrating.
Yeah, a bit unlucky on the save there. I mean.
Yeah, that was terrible.
So I got 2 points for Brit no prisoners and 3 points for bring it down. So 5 points total in that turn. And then it's shipped over to you.
Is that 5 on secondaries, yeah?
5 total on secondaries, yeah. 2 for no prisoners, 3 for bring it down.
Are you got rid of extend battle lines, didn't you? And you
binned off that, yeah.
No prisoners.
And I go up to a CP.
Are you get 4 for bring it down. Because it's on tactical, you get an extra...
Oh, okay, yeah.
4.
So I've got
4 6. For bringing down and 2 points for no prisoners.
Cool, so 6 overall.
So primary. Good. 10. What's your OC over here, Luke?
2 per, so 20.
2.6. And you would have manoeuvred them all, so they're all on, I presume?
Yeah, I mean, there might be like the odd one for the to be within range of demo charges.
Okay, so how many demo charges?
4.
4, and they needed to be within 6?
Within 6, so I can't remember exactly where you had him.
He just gone into the deployment zone, didn't he?
Oh, yeah, that's right, actually. So he was 12 inches of the deployment zone. So his butt was hanging over a bit like that.
Yeah.
So if we say something like that. So to be within 6, I'd have to get... So I could get him on the objective still.
Good question, Toby. I'll have a look, my friend. All right, Ali, thanks for joining us, matey. How are you doing, kiddo?
Off. So that would be 18.
So that would be... 8 to 2, yes. 18.
With some fun games earlier, Ali, of Dead or Alive, which I think you'd appreciate.
So you're going to get 10 on that. So I need to deploy Homer in your DZ.
There is the answer to the question, Toby.
Well, that's what this guy can do, right?
Yeah. What's the OC here?
One each. So, I mean, there's 1, 2, 3 guys, I think, that are not on there.
And you've got 10 in the unit?
Yes, yeah, so 7 OC.
7 OC. Okay, so, got up a CB, I roll for the extra. I actually get it.
Hey.
That becomes sticky, so I still control it at the end.
Mm-hmm.
So, what I will do is, I will... Knight of Shade this one, just to jump on.
Yeah.
So I out OC you now?
Yep.
And that's basically...
That's all you really need to do, isn't it? Yeah.
So, deploy Homers I've done, and then end game scoring.
So you've got 12 for Homers altogether, yeah?
Yes. End game scoring, you control 1 for an additional 5 points.
Yeah.
And I control... Up to 3 for an additional 15.
Plus 15. So you had 10 at the start of your turn, didn't you? Plus 15. So 10, 20, 30, 40. So
87, 81 to me.
Just give us your primary, get total primary. Just under.
For Luke is 35 out of 50.
Oh, no, for you, mate, sorry.
45 out of 50.
So what's your final score on...
87. 87.
Oh!
45, and then...
Luke's disappeared.
12.
Luke's
gone. Back
to his burrow. Luke's had enough, he's just disappeared.
87.
So on a 2-up, he comes back.
Yeah.
There he is.
He's back, yeah. And he emerges just on cue.
Have you given me too many points?
No, I don't think so.
6.
He's got it.
35, and then I've got 36 on secondaries.
35, 36, yeah, plus your painted points.
And you're at
81. Oh, okay, fine. Painted.
Yeah.
Go to
the end of the table.
Go to the end of the table, boys.
We've got an end debrief from that one.
That was a hell of a game.
GSA, you're a pain.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, good close. I didn't think I'd have that at the end, to be fair.
I was. The one thing that happened that I was very nervous of was exactly what you did at the end, which was just to sit on the thing and get the 15.
Yeah.
Because I thought I did a good job of denying you a lot of scoring. A bit of a misstep with the Nurglings there. It would have been nice to have denied you that opportunity. Mm. If I'd done that, it might not have stopped you from scoring because you had the other guy that could have done it
instead
of charging. But then that meant I might have had another thing running around to do some more damage. I don't know. Yeah, it's just, in the end, just a bit too much. I think it would have been nice that turn where I dropped there to have just killed those two. And then that would have kept the Acolytes... It might not have kept the Acolytes alive, but it would have meant that you were spreading out some of your damage a bit more.
Yeah.
So then I could maybe just have a bit more of an ability to claim an objective, whereas you just stomping that meant that when I had that other turn where I was thinking, oh, can I try and not zero you again, but I wasn't ever going to stop you getting 10. You consistently got 10. It started off well, giving you the zero, but I didn't quite keep that momentum going. Yeah. If I'd managed to get another couple of turns of five, that might have actually mm-hmm. been quite good.
I think once you dropped these here, I decided to leave them alone then, because you had to have something on that objective.
Yeah.
Which is why, as you saw, I shuffled back that way to take that side of the board.
Yeah.
And,
great game, boys, and congratulations to Callum going through to the next round of the Epic Flail Invitational, which we're doing. I think Liam's organised them every Thursday, which Georgia, I haven't quite broken the full news to Georgia about that yet, but I appreciate you guys. Thanks for playing again. It was a really, really good, tight game. Worked quite well on the clock. Thanks so much to the chat getting involved throughout. Fun games of Dead or Alive there. I enjoyed the Dead or Alive games and everyone's participation and support of the channel. Appreciate those. Big shout out to Toby, who gifted a bunch of memberships and was an absolute G. So thank you, matey. We appreciate you a lot. Look forward to getting you on for some games. And yeah, thanks so much for watching and cheers to you both for playing the game. Do you want to see a final goodbyes, gents, and I'll end the stream.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, everyone. Nice. Cheers, folks. Take it easy. Look after